183-pound freshman redshirt. There you have the starting lineups for today's ball game. Back with more after this. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
The status of a downtown building in Bedford has been a concern since fire damaged the structure. She says the next step is to winterize the building.
Stabilize the walls, put a roof on it, and supports as necessary. Maybe even the front windows and tums, as well as the basement, and which would probably be the council rooms, and then that could double for a community room or whatever else uses we might have for it.
Ewart says another reason the council decided to save the building is the historical significance to the Bedford community.
I think without a doubt it's probably the best building that was left in town on Main Street, number one. Then it was the old Aaron's
evening in the Northwest Conference Center. The dinner and evening of Madrigals will begin at 6:30. Dr. Richard Wymuth is the director of this annual event.
Welcome back to Rick and Broad Stadium, Northwest and IUP in the semifinals of the NCAA Division II playoffs. Let's go down on the sidelines and check in with Neil Dunker.
Well, John, it's been wet and raining most of the pregame here, but it hasn't stopped the fans from coming in. A steady file still coming into the reserve seats. The student section over on the other side of the field is full, and you've got people trickling off all around to the sides of the field all over the place and very loud down here. The field is a little bit wet. They had it covered all week long, but as the game went on right now, or as the pregame goes on, the game got wetter and wetter as the rain kept coming down. Saw a few people slipping as they were running pass patterns. I went out and ran one. I was actually okay. I've got the long cleats on. I took some advice from Dave Purnell. He was putting some long cleats on too. He said that he was slipping while he was kicking, so he was putting on some longer cleats, and everything should be fine right now. Guys got the longer cleats on, and everybody's ready to go down here.
All right, thank you, Neil. We'll be back with the kickoff right after this timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Northwest Missouri Cellular, 660-582-3334, where nothing but the sky offers better coverage.
Northwest Alumni Association. These two new fraternity houses have certainly raised the bar for Northwest Greek community, and your Alumni Association stands up today to say, we're extremely proud of all your efforts. These two stately structures reside on West 9th in Maryville and are really a sight to behold. And I can assure you that there's immense pride in our campus, and I welcome you to make the return to Northwest Missouri State University for a stroll down memory lane. And better yet, why don't you stop by the Alumni House, climb aboard our six-passenger Bearcat 1 golf cart. It really is a great way to see campus and all its beauty. This is Mike Johnson for Northwest Alumni Association as we're making strides, as all successful Bearcats do.
Welcome back to Rick and Bros Stadium, along with Matt Gorder and Neil Ducker. I'm John Coffey. We're set to go as IUP will be kicking off. We'll be going from our left to our right at Rick and Bros Stadium in front of a great crowd. And here comes the kick. It's a high end-over-end kick, and it'll be taken by Tony Miles at the 10-yard line. He'll angle out to the left side to the 15, cuts back into the 20 to the 25, and he's tripped up at the 28-yard line. That's where Northwest Missouri State will take over first and 10. Making the tackle was Tom Reibholz for IUP, and the Bearcats in pretty good field position to start this game.
Yeah, it looks the way that first kick return went there. That should be something that'll be effective for the Bearcats. Hopefully they don't have to do too many kick returns, meaning IUP isn't scoring any points, but a good start to the ball game on the first play.
And for the Bearcats, that quarterback, Travis Miles, backfield of David Jansen. Tony Miles will go wide to the right side. Seneca Holmes also to the right side. J.R. Hill over to the left side. And now they send Jansen back to the tailback. He lined up initially as a slot back. And motion Tony Miles to the left side on first down play action. Travis Miles rolls to the right side, pumps once, now goes deep right sideline. Has Seneca Holmes open, he catches it at the 40-yard line into IUP territory for first down at the 38-yard line. Pass just a little bit underthrown. Seneca came back after it, and the Bearcats having a great field position now in Indian territory.
Well, Seneca Holmes picking up where he left off last week at 169 yards receiving with a touchdown against Northern Colorado. Gets the first catch of the ball game here, so Seneca showing he's just going to continue to play well in the playoffs.
First and 10 for Northwest now in IUP territory at the 38-yard line. This game just underway. High formation now is Tucker Woolsey in the backfield, and back to and a draw play goes to Jansen off to the right side, and he stood up for maybe 1 yard gain on the play. Runs into Roger Wilson, a defensive end for IUP, and this will bring up second down.
Well, they stuffed it up pretty good there. The offensive line is going to have a very big test here today. That defensive line of IUP is very good, very tested. They have played well this year, so it's going to be a tough day for the offensive line. They're really going to have have to work hard.
Second down and 9 for Northwest. Seneca Holmes to the left side. Seneca coming off a great game last week against Northern Colorado. Out of the backfield, Mark Moss goes in motion and will line up as a tight end left side. Tony Miles over to the right. Back in the pocket is Travis Miles. Throws. Caught. Left sideline. Reception to Mark Moss at the 30. He's down to the 28-yard line. That's close to another first down. And the secondary to make the tackle was Joey Flora, cornerback for IUP.
Boy, you think back to earlier in the year about Travis getting started and getting out here, getting used to being on the field, being the starter. It's night and day the way things are right now. Travis looks so comfortable, stands in the pocket, sees all his receivers, looks off receivers, just does a great job.
Brian George out there as a receiver now to the right side, along with Seneca Holmes and Tony Miles. Single set is Jansen. Jansen takes the pitch and drops it, picks it back up, tries to go to the right side at 30, and does a good job getting back close to the line of scrimmage. Broke a couple tackles before coming over and having James Tindall, a strong safety, to make the tackle.
That's one thing that we're going to have to look out for is drop balls, fumbled balls, and it'll go both ways with the ball a little bit wet. I don't think it's raining right now, but even if it isn't, the grass out there is wet. The football, of course, lies in the grass before the play starts, so it's going to be just a little bit slick.
Second down and 11 for Northwest. Holmes to the right side. To the left side, Tony Miles. Shotgun formation now for Travis Miles. Tucker Woolsey and Jansen in the backfield as Tony Miles goes in motion. Back to pass is Travis in the pocket, and he's going toward the goal line on the right side, up in the air, tipped away, and it goes incomplete. John Pancake, a defensive back, was going step for step with Seneca Holmes, got a hand on it, knocks it away, and this will bring up third down.
Good job there.
Tim Buffone, also Roger Wilson on that defensive line. Now on third down and 11, J.R. Hill to the left side, Tony Miles to the left, and in motion goes Comer, the tight end, to the left side. Shotgun formation again for Travis. Back in the pocket, quick pass, and it's batted away, incomplete. This will bring up fourth down.
Yeah, Faraji Mason got his big hand up in the air and knocked that one down on that front line. Otherwise, he had Comer wide open right over the middle.
Brings up fourth down. And the punting, right now the field goal unit coming out as Dave Purnell will set this one down at the 35-yard line. So a 45-yard attempt for David Purnell. His long this year, 48. He had a good week last week against Northern Colorado.
He was kicking them from 60 warming up this morning.
Going into the wind on this one. And a 45-yard attempt from the right hash. Ball down. The kick is on the way. And it is no good. Just short. Just short. So Northwest comes up short on their first possession. IUP will take over, and we'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Hopkins, Savannah, and St. Joseph. Member FDIC.
On first down for IUP, a handoff to Terrence Wilson, the tailback. He goes up the middle with it, crosses the 30, and gets to the 32-yard line. This will bring up second down for IUP on their first possession. Again, they go from our left to our right, and Northwest Missouri State and IUP scoreless at this point.
Well, the way they rely on the running game like they do, it'll be interesting to see. You heard Neil talk a little bit about how the field was a little bit slick, but usually good running backs can overcome that.
Second down and 6 coming up for the Indians. Offset I formation, receivers to the right and left, and the freshman quarterback Ironman with a handoff left side, and Terrence Wilson gets the carry, nothing doing. He stopped for a loss of 1.
Have to be encouraged about how the first couple of runs have gone for IUP as far as the Bearcats are concerned, as they stopped one after about a 4 or 5 yard gain. Just a nice run, really, by Terrence Wilson on the first try, but here, just a great job up front. Linebackers were able to come up and make the tackle.
Greg Bonnard there to make the stop that time, coming off a great game last week. He had 10 tackles against the Bears. Third down at 6 for IUP. Greg Dorsey will go wide to the right side. Casey will do the left side, and back to pass is Ironman. Rush comes in, gets the pass left side, and it's caught on the left at the 40 to the 45. Breaks a tackle. The penalty marker falls out to the 45-yard line. That should be a first down. Brian Williams with the tackle, but a penalty marker down. It's holding against IUP.
Yeah, so this one's coming back. The hold occurred at the 30, or rather the 28-yard line, so this is going to mark them all the way back inside the 20-yard line, which is great for the Bearcats. It'll be third down once again, so they're going to start winning some field position here, and that's exactly what IUP tries to do. They play that field position war, which Northwest really lost most of the game against Northern Colorado this week, so it'll be key to pick that up.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
This is your Choice FM 90.5 KXCV Maryville and 88.9 KRNW Chillicothe. Currently 41 degrees at your Choice FM.
Third and 15 for IUP. Single set with two receivers to the left side. Brian Arriman at quarterback will hand off to the left side. The handoff goes to Terrence Wilson. He stopped for little or no gain. He gets to the 25-yard line, and this will force the Indians to punt.
Boy, the defense came ready to play as well. Wow. What a great job there in pursuit. Had about four or five guys get their hats on the ball there, pick up the stop, and everybody was around the football and around the play for the defense. That's something we're going to need to do all day. It can't be just through a series or two.
Fourth down, punting situation. Tony Miles back deep to return this punt. He's lining up at the 35-yard line. And to punt this one will be Matt Dannell. Dannell, a 6-foot junior out of Portage, Pennsylvania. Good snap. Rush comes in, just gets it away. It's an end-over-end kick and away from Tony. We'll take a bounce at the 30 and goes out of bounds at the 28-yard line, where Northwest will have it first and 10. Back after this 30-second timeout, you're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
And the pictures are all in your head.
You can hear a Prairie Home Companion Saturdays at 5 and again Sundays at 3 on KXCV, KRNW.
First and 10 for Northwest. The pitch goes to the right side to David Jansen. He tries to turn the corner, run out of bounds. As he's run out of bounds near the 28-29-yard line, the Bearcats and IUP no score this game in the first quarter. 10-10 left in the first quarter. Semifinals of the Division II playoffs.
Well, it looks the way both defensive has played here early on. The run isn't going to be very effective for either team, at least at this point. But the good thing about that is the Bearcats have had much more success throwing the football this year.
Second down and 9 for Northwest. Ryan George, Seneca Holmes to the left side. Tony Miles over to the right side. Also, J.R. Hill, single set backfield as Travis Miles at quarterback with a long count this time. Three-step drop. Throws right sideline cut. Tony Miles with the reception. Tries to cut back. He's hit and will be dropped after about a 4-yard gain. Tried to make a quick cut move, but couldn't get away from John Pancake, the first one to hold on to him. Then he had several others come over to help out, including Quincy Tisdale, an outside linebacker for IUP.
Well, IUP is going to key on Tony Miles. We already saw him punt away from Tony, so he can't get his catches here and there, have a decent day, and we can have somebody like a Seneca or even a Ryan George or J.R. Hill step up and have a great day receiving. We're going to be all right.
Third down and 5 for Northwest. I formation, Tucker Woolsey as the fullback. Tony Miles in motion left side. And they roll to the left side to play action to throw the ball. Travis Miles caught by Tony at the 41-yard line. Good for a first down. Tony leaped in the air, brought it down. John Pancake to make the tackle on the catch with the first down.
Or even if they key on Tony Miles and he has a big day, that'll work out too. It doesn't matter who does it as long as we get one or maybe two.
9:17 left, first quarter. Again, no score. Bearcats with their second possession at the 42-yard line on the left hash.
First and 10 from the 42.
Seneca Holmes to the left side. J.R. Hill to the right side. Tony Miles also to the right side in a shotgun formation for Northwest. As Hill goes in motion left. Quick handoff goes to Jansen. Jansen cuts back left side past the 45-yard line to the 49-yard line. There'll be a gain of 6, maybe 7 on the play as he gets into the secondary. Mike Borisenko, an inside linebacker, to make the tackle. That's a guy we talked about in our pregame, Matt. That is the one to watch for out of that IUP defense.
Yep, he was the defensive player of the year in the western portion of their conference this year. So he's been the key for this defense. He's been the big guy, just like Brian Williams is our guy on our defense.
Second down and a long 2 for the Bearcats, just shy of midfield. Tony Miles wide to the right. J.R. Hill to the left side and a wide split backfield as Travis Miles behind center Joe Glab with a play action. Two-step rock pass right side. And quick sliding pattern is caught by Tony Miles for another first down at the 41 in IUP territory. And Joey Florent to make the tackle, defensive back for IUP.
Hey, you can already see a little bit of frustration in this IUP defense. After the play, you always see a little smack on the back of the pads from the defender on the receiver. The play before, Borisenko kind of swatted Jansen on the back of the shoulder pads there in a little bit of frustration. So already starting to set in here. If we can get these guys frustrated this early in the game, that could be huge.
From the 42 of the Indians, Northwest, first and 10. Offset eye, receivers left side. Back to pass is Travis Miles. Deep drop. They want to set up the screen. Pass left side, caught by Jansen. Jansen to the 40. He's to the 35. Tripped up from behind as he gets to the 35-yard line. Tim Buffone to make the tackle. The nose guard. His uncle played for the Chicago Bears back in the 1960s. He's out of Sagamore, Pennsylvania.
Good hustle by Buffone. He was going the opposite direction of that play there and then saw that Jansen was going out and they were setting up the screen. So he got on his high horse right away and tried to cut off the path of David Jansen and was able to catch him from behind.
Just shy of the 35-yard line for the Bearcats as they're into IUP territory. J.R. Hill to the left side. Right side, Seneca Holmes. In motion, Mark Moss out of the backfield as he lined up initially as a fullback. Now Tony Miles goes in motion right. And the give, left side to Jansen. Jansen turns on the left at the 30-yard line, breaks a tackle. He's to the 29, and that's good for another first down as the Bearcats keep their drive going. And John Pancake, one of those to make the tackle for IUP.
IUP having a little bit of trouble tackling here in that first series on running plays. They had no problems wrapping up David Jansen and dropping him, but this time Jansen's able to break some tackles. He slid through a few and picked up some good yardage after being hit for the first time.
First and 10 for Northwest, now to the 27-yard line. Ryan George to the right, also J.R. Hill and Tony Miles. And a shotgun formation again for Travis. He's back in the pockets. They send everyone out. Has time, looks, throws across middle, caught by Scott Quarter. And Quarter brought down at the 24-yard line. That'll be about four on the play for Scott, the senior out of Maryville. Just his sixth reception of the season. 6:46 left in the first quarter, no score. Bearcats on their second drive, marching it into IUP territory. Great balanced drive this time, Matt.
Yeah, and they're moving it a little bit better this time. They had one big play that really moved it last time. Now they're just punching it 5-10 yards at a time.
Offset eye, receivers both sides. Pitch goes right side to Ryan Hackett, who wants to throw the ball as a halfback, and he launches it high in the air, hangs up there, and it is incomplete as Northwest receiver J.R. Hill turned into a defender that time. Pass just caught high in the air, and John Pancake was in position to make the play, and a good job by J.R. just knocking it away.
Well, and J.R. Hill is giving up a couple inches to Pancake there, and that one was lofted in the air and did a good job to come around and get his hand on the football because he was well behind. Matter of fact, you couldn't really even see J.R. Hill behind Pancake because he's got a little bit of size on him there, but a good job at least knocking it down to the ground incomplete.
Ryan Hackett just had a hard time getting a grip on the ball to throw it downfield. Now they spread to the backfield. All the way, everyone's out. Three receivers to the left, two to the right side. And Travis Miles behind center. Quick pass right side goes to Seneca Holmes. Stutter steps around one defender. Pass the 20 to the 18-yard line. This will bring up fourth down and about three for Northwest. Travis Miles indicating it might even be closer than that.
That pass by Ryan Hackett, that's the seventh Bearcat to throw a pass this season. We have seen them pull a lot of plays out of their playbook. Coach Fabota doesn't mind doing that type of stuff. Not afraid to do so. As a matter of fact, with Travis Miles catching a touchdown, what does that tell you about what you can see out of this team?
Fourth and two, another field goal attempt by Dave Purnell. His last one from 45 yards came up just short. This time from the 25, so a 35-yard attempt from the right hash into a bit of a breeze. The ball down, the kick is on the way, line drive kick, and this one is wide to the left side. So he's 0 for 2 so far this afternoon. 5:40 left in the quarter, no score, and we'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio.
University, the Bearcats, and Nottoway Valley Bank, member FDIC, all winning teams.
Back at Rickenbro Stadium on first down for IUP, a pass play goes off of the right side and it goes incomplete. And this will be a second down situation out for IUP. They try to get it out of the backfield to fullback Tom Reibholtz, who's a pretty good receiver out of the backfield. He had 11 catches this year. That time couldn't hold on to it. This brings up second down and 10 for Indiana University of Pennsylvania from their 20-yard line.
Reibholtz also got hit a little bit early from behind as Greg Bonnet was coming up from behind, but no penalty on the play.
Greg Dorsey wide to the left side. Also Derek Brinkley to the left. Single set this time for IUP. And the handoff going right side for Terrence Wilson. Good hole opens up, breaks loose from untackle, past the 25 out near the 30, should have a first down. Joe Quinlan tried to wrap him up at the 25, couldn't hold on to him. And that enabled Terrence Wilson to pick up the first down. Wilson, one of two tailbacks who've rushed for over 1,000 yards this year for the Indians.
Joe Quinlan is going to have a big ball game defensively for the Cats. He's going to be in there and he's going to get a lot more minutes than he usually does with Wes Simmons out after suffering a shoulder injury early in the ball game last week against Northern Colorado.
Carmelo Ocaso wide to the right side. To the left side, Greg Dorsey in an I formation backfield. Northwest with five down linemen on this first down play for IUP. And the pitch goes left side. And they got it to Amar Du for the first time. He tries to go left side, breaks loose from one tackle, past the 30, and gets back to the line of scrimmage. Brian Williams, the one to make the tackle. David Carlson also comes over to help out for the Cats.
Kind of a rough start for his first running play. Du caught the pitch there and really bobbled it and had to concentrate more on trying to make sure he held onto the football and didn't drop it than looking for a hole there. And by the time he got control of it, he didn't have much time to look up and find some room.
IUP has done a very good job recruiting around the Pennsylvania area, but they're two tailbacks, which have rushed, as we mentioned, for over 1,000 yards apiece, and one from Louisiana and the other from New Jersey. Second down and 8 for the Indians. Offset eye, back to pass is Brian Armand, the freshman quarterback. Pass left side cut, but not much room as Ripholz brings it in at the 35-yard line, and this will bring up third down for the Indians.
IUP's been going to those quick hitters when they drop back to pass, so you'd like to see the Bearcats have an opportunity to get in the backfield and rough up Ironman just a little bit, get some knocks on him as he tries to pass the football, maybe unsettle him a little bit. We saw Northwest get a big hit from David Carlson last week and knock Court McGuffey woozy in the second half. So something we'd like to see happen again.
4 minutes left in the first quarter, no score. Receivers to the right and left on third down and 6 for IUP. On their 35, three-step drop, Armand with the pass cut and a reception left side to the 45 to midfield and into Northwest territory at the 49-yard line as they got just the quick hitting pass to the left side and a first down for IUP.
Good job there, Ryan Miller, to hold on and make sure he got the tackle there. He was the last line of defense. If they get by Ryan Miller, it's 6 points for IUP. So a good job of wrapping up and holding on to make the stop.
So into Northwest territory, IUP, at the 49-yard line from our left to our right. On a cool and damp day in Maryville. Receivers to the right side, offset I formation backfield. Back to passes, Ironman looks, throws, pass left sideline, is caught near a first down and out of bounds. Pass reception to John Jones, the tight end. Into double coverage, David Carlson was there. Also some help from Ryan Miller, but a good job by Jones to haul it in, the Cleveland, Ohio native, and close to also played some defensive end at Pitt as well. Receivers to the right and left side, first and 10 with a single set. Amir Du, the single setback, two tight ends this time, and the handoff goes to Du. Huge hole up the middle. He's past the 35 and to the 33-yard line. Miller there to make the stop for Northwest, and also coming up to help out Greg Bonnet.
Well, the defense had a good first series against IUP and really shut them down. They got some help from a holding penalty, but IUP has started to move the football well here in their second possession.
At the 33 of Northwest, 3:03 left in a fast-paced first quarter. Receivers to the right side this time, Greg Dorsey, also Carmelo Ocaso, offset I formation, and back to pass is Ironman. As Buckwalter comes in, gets him by one, Ironman throws him to the ground, back at the 45-yard line. Good job by Alan Buckwalter, his fifth sack of the season.
Good job by Buckwalter getting in the backfield there. I thought for a moment there that he might have gotten his hand a little too high and got a piece of Ironman's face mask, but no penalty comes out, so just a good tackle there by Buckwalter. And instead of a holding penalty, a sack will work just as well.
Third down and 15 with 2:23 left in the first quarter. Again, back to the 43-yard line. Alan Buckwalter, a 6'2", 242-pound senior out of Palmyra, Missouri, with the big play defensively. This time they sent two receivers to the right, two to the left, and a slot to the right side. Into and back to passes. Ironman on third and long. Pass is knocked down, and guess who blocks that one? Alan Buckwalter slaps it down. So two very big plays by Buckwalter.
And we're not going to see a field goal attempt here by IUP. The long for them so far this year is only 31 yards. So the Bearcats are going to be able to get the football back here on this fourth down. What a big sack there by Buckwalter, and then able to help get the Bearcats the football back by knocking the pass down.
Matt Daniel, before his second punt of the day, he punted it away from Tony Miles the last time. Averages 38.1 yards per punt this season. IUP in their traveling white uniform tops with the crimson numerals and pants and the gray helmets with the red striping. Good snap. And he gets this one away. An end over end punt. And Tony Miles lets it bounce at the 5-yard line. And it will roll. Does it get into the end zone? No, it's down to the 1-yard line. Took a bad hop and rolls out of bounds, officially at the 2-yard line, where Northwest Missouri State will take over. No score. Back in 30 seconds, you're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Nottoway Valley, your hometown bank, is a proud sponsor of Bearcat Sports. We salute Northwest athletes who at Hopkins, Savannah, and St. Joseph. Member FDIC.
On first down from the 2-yard line, the handoff goes to David Jansen. Jansen gets to the line of scrimmage, and not much there for Northwest, and this will bring up second down for the Bearcats. Deep in their own territory, 1:44 left in the first quarter, and no score.
Yeah, the Bearcats trying to get a little bit of room here. As you mentioned about that bounce, John, goes right out at the 2-yard line, and it was a good decision by Tony Miles to let that punt hit. It landed right at the 5-yard line, and you're almost sure it's going to go into the end zone, but good bounce for IUP.
Second down and 9 after 1-yard gain by Jansen. Now the tight end, Mark Moss, lines up as a fullback in an offset eye formation. Tony Miles to the right side. Back to pass in the end zone as Travis Miles throws on the sideline. Caught by Cedric Holmes out of bounds. Brings it out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Good job on the pattern, and he kept his feet inbounds for the reception and a first down for Northwest.
I think John Pancake thought Seneca was going to go deep there. Pancake was about 5 to 6 yards off of Seneca when he made that cut to the sideline, left him wide open.
First and 10 for Northwest at the 17-yard line. 1:12 left in the first quarter. No score. Alongside with Matt Gorder, Neil Dunker, I'm John Coffey. From the 17 first down, Mark Moss slips as he goes out of the backfield and lines up as a tight end. Back to passes, Travis throws right sideline, cut, reception on the right at the 21-yard line. And there to make the catch for Northwest was Seneca Holmes again. Holmes got in a double team, but brings it down for a reception, about 5 yards on the game.
Talked about how Seneca Holmes is really starting where he left off last week. That's the fourth catch, and already 56 yards receiving for Seneca Holmes.
Another semifinal matchup in Division II football this afternoon. Carson Newman, 7, and Northeastern Oklahoma, nothing. That was 7:47 left in the first quarter. Here, no score. Offset eye backfield as Moss moves into a fullback position. The handoff goes to Jensen. Huge hole up the middle. He's to the 25-yard line. Darts to the 30, and he's to the 31-yard line. A first down for David Jensen. Great cut by Jensen, picking him up about 4 more yards as he is able to get out and pick up the first down before Adam Boylan, free safety, makes the tackle.
Shows you what a balanced attack can do. The very first play of this drive, back at the 2-yard line, IUP expected the run. Jensen couldn't get anything. Then they get a couple of passes to Seneca Holmes, and it opens up the running attack right away for Jensen. As far as passing goes, Miles is 10 of 12 passing already for 99 yards.
And Jensen, 6 carries, 36 yards. First and 10 for Northwest at the 32-yard line with 9 seconds left in the quarter. Very quick first quarter. Wide to the left side goes Tony Miles, and back to pass is Travis. Play action, throws right side, overthrown, incomplete. Trying to get it to Mark Moss, overthrown by about 5 yards, incomplete, and this will bring up second down. As the clock winds down, that's the end of the first quarter. No score. Northwest and IUP in the Division II. With Neil Dunker and Matt Gorder, I'm John Coffey. We go to the second quarter. Northwest now from our left to our right with the wind to their back. Play action, and now the handoff goes left side for Jensen. Jensen, huge hole. He's off to the left side, past the 35, 40, and a first down out to the 43-yard line as Jensen did a great job hitting that hole very quickly, and a penalty marker falls after the play.
Yeah, we had a little bit of talking after the play here, so we'll have to wait and punch one in here and get 7 points up on the board and get a lead. It doesn't look like maybe a touchdown or two leads probably going to be pretty safe in a ball game like this.
High formation, Tucker Wolsey in the backfield as the fullback. Two receivers to the right, Tony Miles, one of those who goes in motion left side. And the handoff goes left side for Jensen. A nice hole opens up past the 35. He's down to the 33-yard line, about 8 yards on first down. David Jensen doing a great job hitting that hole, and let's credit the offensive line for also opening things up.
Jensen is up over 50 yards already, and that just shows you the balance. We've got Travis with almost 100 yards passing, sitting at 99. And for Jansen, that's his 8th carry for 57 yards. You balance it out like that, now you just got to put some points on the board with it.
That time they went off of the left side of the offensive line behind two first-team MIAA performers in left tackle Andrew Pilding and left guard Chad Thompson. Single set and Jansen, two receivers to the right. Northwest in a double tight end formation this time on 2nd and 1. But back to passes, Travis Miles out of the backfield. Jansen with the reception as he goes to the 35, to the 30, to the 25-yard line on the sideline, to the 20. First down Northwest as the Bearcats driving. And another good job by David Jansen just running that sideline before finally being hauled down by Eric Neff, a defensive end.
Really, you can down and then make the cut instead of just going from full speed.
20 miles to the left side, to the right side, Seneca Holmes. Again, two tight ends, Moss to the right and Comer to the left. Now Moss will drop back as a fullback in the I formation. And the draw play goes to Jensen up the middle to the 15-yard line, down to the 14-yard line. And there'll be a gain of about 5, maybe 6 once again. And David Jensen with a great job as he's averaging probably about 5 yards a carry so far, and the hole's opening up for him.
Well, the good thing there, the reason that draw play works so well is the linebackers are thinking pass first, and when Miles stopped, he set up like he was going to drop back and pass. It gave the linebackers just 1 second to think about it and opened up some space there for Jensen.
Jensen single set this time. Receivers to the right and left. Tony Miles in motion left side. Handoff up the middle. Jensen again to the 10-yard line. Down to the 9. That's a first down. It'll be first and goal for Northwest. Mike Warnsenko to make the tackle for IUP.
Very impressive. We've had 3 very good drives here. A couple of them ending with a missed field goal, so which is going to happen. I mean, they're not necessarily that big a deal, especially with the way we've been moving the football. We just need to tack some points onto the end of one of these.
So it's first and goal for Northwest from the 9-yard line. Second quarter just underway. No score. Northwest and IUP in the semifinals of the Division II playoffs. From the 9-yard line, Northwest from our left to our right. Ryan George to the left. Tucker Wolsey and Jansen, backfield in an I formation. And again, Jansen up the middle. Tries to go off to the left side, past the 5, down to the 4-yard line. That time, Glavin Thompson opened the way for Jansen to run, and he goes down to the 4-yard line. This will bring up second and goal.
Boy, that offensive line has really started to step it up here. They had a little bit of a trouble the first couple series, but they have made the necessary adjustments that they needed to, and they've just opened things up for David Jansen here on this drive.
To the 4-yard line, second and goal. Jared James, a tight end out there as well, as the Bearcats go with their 3 tight end formation. And back to passes. Travis Miles throws toward the goal line. Incomplete. Try to get it to James at the goal line. John Pancake stepped in front of him, distracting him. The ball goes incomplete. This brings up third down.
And Pancake may have just gotten a fingertip on that football there. A little bit hard to tell from up here, but he may have just gotten a touch on it and knocked it just enough to where James wasn't able to come up with it.
Pancake, another one of those players who's taken advantage of an injury in front of him. He was listed as the second defensive back at that right corner position. The injury early in the year has enabled Pancake to come in and play very well. He had 2 interceptions last week in their win over Millersville. White split in the backfield on third and goal from the 4-yard line. Back to passes. Travis rolls left side, lobs it high in the air toward the end zone. Caught, touchdown! Reception to Ryan George off of the left side, and the Bearcats strike first with 12 minutes left in the first half.
What a great adjustment by Ryan George. He goes out in that little fade pattern out there, was looking to the middle over his right shoulder. Miles threw it to the left shoulder toward the outside, and a good throw by Miles because he was throwing away from the defender. But George made the adjustment, got his head on a swivel, turned it around, saw the football, made the catch, touchdown Bearcats.
5th touchdown of the year for Ryan George, who missed a few games due to a knee injury. Bearcats in front, 6-0. Out for the point after attempt is David Purnell. Perfect on the air as he's hit 63 straight this year. Good snap ball down. The kick is on the way, and Purnell drills it. And the Bearcats lead 7-0 with 12 minutes left in the first half. We'll be back after this 1-minute timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network. The Rick and Broad Stadium with Matt Gorder and Neil Ducker. I'm John Coffey. Northwest just scoring as they had a 13-play, 98-yard drive and a pass play into the end zone to Ryan George, and the Bearcats in front now 7-0 down the sidelines. And Neil Ducker.
Well, John and Matt, something you guys might have noticed before: Leander Jordan, big number 76, offensive guard, was down here on the goal line defense for IUP. Something else you might want to notice with Leander's: he's flip-flopping sides of the center. He's on the right side one play, he's on the left side another play, and they seem to be following him with the run. Back up to you guys.
All right, thank you, Neil. As Dave Purnell will kick off, 7-0 Northwest Missouri State in front, and here comes the kick as he gets into it. A high end over end kick. The wind to his back, and it's taken at the 2-yard line off to the left side. Taken out past the 10 to the 15-yard line. It's just shy of the 15-yard line, and field conditions may have played a factor in Joey Flora. He slipped as he took the kick, and he just gets out to the 15, and the Bearcats also did a good job on the special teams there.
I think another thing that plays a factor there is the fact that this crowd is fired up. The team is fired up. Once you get in that end zone for the first time and you've got the lead, it's put a little bit of spark in everybody here, and I think the crowd just waiting for that. They need to get up, jump around, and do some cheering just to keep warm.
That's true. Offset eye backfield, receivers to the right and left side for IUP. Now in motion, the fullback Reibholz to the left side, and the handoff going to or the right to Terrence Wilson. Tries to go right side past the 15. Gets out to the 17 to the 18-yard line on a first down play. Brian Williams was there to make the tackle. Let's pause 10 seconds for a station identification. You're 3-yard gain, and it brings up second down and 7 with 11:18 left in the first half. 2 receivers to the left side, single set backfield, and the quarterback Ironman rolls left, wants to throw an incomplete. As he turned to throw the ball, he saw coming in Alan Buckwalter right in his face and hustled to get rid of the ball. It goes incomplete. He's trying to get it to John Jones, his tight end.
Boy, Alan Buckwalter continues to play huge. The last drive for IUP really was stopped by Alan Buckwalter. The last 2 plays of the drive, he was able to come up with big plays for the Bearcats.
Third down and 7 for the Indians. Northwest in their home uniforms, all green this time. Last week they wore their silver pants, which they opened up as a home pant on the road. They're in all green with the white numerals and the green helmets. Split formation backfield, two receivers, one to the left, one to the right, back to passes, Ironman in the pocket, ring pressured, rolls, looks, throws right sideline, and it is caught. Wilson reception at the 20. He's out of bounds near the 25-yard line and close to the first down marker. Knocked out of bounds by Bonnet on the far side along with Ryan Miller.
John, you talk about those uniforms, kind of an interesting point here. The seniors, and something we haven't mentioned today, are playing their final game here at Rick and Broad Stadium. Win or lose today, they don't come back here, and when the team, they vote on what uniform they wear from week to week, and when they were trying to decide what to wear this week, the senior said, you know, hey, we came in wearing all green. That's what they wore when these guys came in. They want to go out wearing all green as well.
And with the addition of the silver pants, they're able to accessorize this year just a little bit and decide which way they want from game to game. Back to pass and draw play instead. Ironman hands off to Wilson on a first down play right up the middle and nothing there. Runs into several, including Jeff Googe at the defensive tackle spot. And this will bring up second down.
There were about three Bearcats there that piled him up right there at the line of scrimmage, and then Matt Vogie came up from behind, just finally wrapped up the whole pile and pushed the pile backwards and stopped the forward progress to make sure that play wasn't going anywhere.
1 yard on the gain, second down and nine for IUP. At the 27-yard line with 10:28 left in the second quarter, Northwest in front, 7-0. Wide to the left side goes Greg Dorsey. Offset eye formation in the backfield. Ironman will give right side, and right side goes to Wilson. Has the first down past the 35 as he shows some speed as he got near the 40-yard line and knocked out of bounds. Terrence Wilson really accelerating as he hit the line of scrimmage off the right side.
Terrence Wilson really knocked hard, too, out of bounds over there, ran into the bench as he rolled all the way through the sidelines, and he's still down over there on that far sideline, so hopefully not too serious for Terrence, but as of right now, he's going to be out of the ballgame, but they've got a pretty good 1-2 punch and a good backup in Amir Dew.
Wilson with 7 carries, 36 yards this afternoon, came in with 1,300 on the season. Craig at Dorsey to the left side, Dew now as the tailback out of an I formation. First and 10 for IUP from their 40-yard line. Back to pass is Ironman. Pressure comes in, and he's going deep left sideline, and it's tipped away. Good job by Charlie Pugh. The pass is intended for Greg Dorsey, and Dorsey had a step on Pugh, but Charlie leaps up in the air, just knocks it away.
Dorsey got up looking for the officials, wanting a flag there, but it wasn't even close. Just a tremendous play by Charlie Pugh as he came up to make that play. Dorsey at 6 feet 2 inches, Charlie Pugh just at 5'9". Pugh timed that jump perfectly. Got up, he was about a yard behind Dorsey, caught up with Dorsey, jumped just in time to get his hand on the football.
And a little bit fortunate, too, that the pass caught up in the air just a little bit, hung there, enabling Charlie to come under it. Second down and 10 for IUP from the 40-yard line, still in their own territory. Receivers right and left. Block out this time by Brian Ehrman, the freshman out of Pittsburgh. Handoff goes to Dew off the right side, breaks a couple tackles to the 40-yard line, and David Carlson wraps him around the ankles and brings him down just shy of the first down marker at the 48.
Now the Bearcats this time with Dew having a little bit of trouble wrapping up. They got a couple of hits on him right at the line of scrimmage, and he was still able to pop out and pick up 9 yards. So wrapping up here this afternoon is going to be key for both teams.
Officials for today's game, referee John Lesser, umpires Mike Carr, linesman is Gary Putt, also line judge Mike Cannonfield, judge is Mike Turek, side judge is Dale Fries. Third down and one for IUP. This year on third down conversions, they've been 26%, 41 of 156 coming into today. Just shy of midfield, offset I formation. Dew with the carry, left side has the first down. As he crosses, ball pops loose, and I believe IUP will recover the fumble at midfield. And picking up the ball was John Jones, the tight end. So John Jones in the right spot at the right time as that ball popped loose.
Oh.
And an injured Bearcat as well. Brian Williams is down.
Oh, no, that's not good. We need Big Brian. And he's not moving much either.
He's face down on the field at the 48. Now he rolls and is up and will come off the field, but it's good to see him get up off his own power, and he's limping off to the field, though.
Yeah, he just laid there really motionless on his stomach, as you mentioned there, John, and then right as the trainers got out there, Williams popped up and stood up, comes off limping pretty heavily, and I'm guessing no matter how much he's injured, we're probably going to see him back in this ballgame.
One of the tougher guys in the lineup for the Bearcats.
Well, not only that, he's the emotional leader as well, and he knows he needs to be out there leading this defense.
First and 10 for IUP at the 49-yard line. Receivers to the right and left with an I formation. Northwest with six along the front line this time on the defensive side. Pitch goes right side to right side, breaks a tackle now, has to reverse field and back to the line of scrimmage and gets 1 yard on the play. Did a heck of a job just picking up 1 yard. Cole Sidwell had a shot at him, missed him. A couple others also had him in the backfield. He squirted loose from them and picks up 1 yard.
John Jones was working against Cole Sidwell over on that far side, and Sidwell just continued to push forward as he just pushed right through John Jones. Jones never lost contact with him, but Cole was able to knock him back into do.
Now we have an injured IUP player. That's Greg Dorsey. He's down the field near the 25-yard line, and he is on his knees and doubled over now all by himself with the training staff away from that play.
Yeah, he was about 30 yards away from that play there. I didn't catch what happened to him. But
on your choice, FM, KXCV, and KRNW.
Dorsey goes to the sideline now, IUP at the line of scrimmage, and audibilizing is Brian Ironman, 8:23 left in the half, Northwest in front 7-0. With the I formation, three-step drop, Ironman wants to throw on the right side, it's knocked loose and incomplete, batted down at the line of scrimmage, falls incomplete, and this will bring up third down and 9.
And just to let you know, Brian Williams is back out there on defense for the Bearcats, and he looks like he's all right, worked just fine there on that last play as he started to drop back into pass coverage, doesn't look to be suffering from the effects of whatever had happened to him a couple of plays ago.
Third and 9 for IUP. And on the Northwest 48-yard line. And a timeout's been called by the Indians. 8:14 left in the score. Northwest Missouri State 7, IUP nothing. Back in a minute. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network. It's third down and 9 for IUP on the Northwest 48-yard line. The Bearcats in front 7-0. Back to passes. Ironman deep drop. Sets. Now looks. Throws left sideline and it is caught for the reception at the 37-yard line. Derek Brinkley brings it in and falls to the ground at the 37. That's good for the first down. Let's go down on the sidelines and Neil Dunker.
John and Matt, just a few plays earlier when Brian Williams was laying down on the field, got up, limped his way over here to the sidelines. Didn't even give the training staff a chance to look at him because while they were on their way over here, he apparently pumped himself back up and was ready to get back out on the field. Was on the field before the training staff even got over to look at him. Back up to you guys.
Apparently nothing too serious. First and 10 for IUP. Big third down conversion for the Indians. On the Northwest 37-yard line, IUP backfield with two receivers, one to the right, one to the left side. And a long count by Ironman. And he gives up to middle. And Terrence Wilson back out there. He's hit at line of scrimmage and dropped for maybe a yard loss. There was Cole Sidwell, the first one to hit him. Brian Williams also there as well. This will bring up second down.
Cole Sidwell continues to play well as he's had to step up here in the playoffs. Has seen quite a bit of playing time because of some injuries. And he's been out there and doing a good job these last couple of ball games.
And the other semifinal game this afternoon, Carson Newman leading Northeastern State of Oklahoma 21-0. That's at the end of the first quarter. Carson Newman trying to get back to the championship game for the second year. Bearcats trying to do the same, and Northwest in front by a touchdown. 7:07 left in the first half. Receivers to the right and left side on second down and 12 after 2 yard loss. Two step drop. Pass by Ironman. Caught right sideline. Reception to Brinkley. Brinkley on a slanting pattern. Close to the first down. And Brian Williams again in the area. And I believe well, let's check the mark here. They should pick up the first down. They're going to bring out the change formation, right? It looks.
Yeah, it's going to be just about as close as you can get here. It's over on that far side. It's too far away for me to make a call. I've been too accurate this year to blow it here.
I think he's going to have it. First down by about half a football.
Yep, just barely had it, but they got it.
So IUP trying to answer back after Northwest had a long drive. This drive for the Indians, 12 plays, and they've gone 46 yards so far. At the 27-yard line, first down for the Indians. Derek Brinkley to the left side. Josh Smart also to the left. And a single set. Back to pass is Ironman. Looks to throw toward the end zone, down the middle for his tight end, and it goes incomplete. David Carlson step for step with John Jones, incomplete in the end zone, and this will bring up second down. On the Northwest 27-yard line, 6:26 left in the first half, a 7-0 Northwest lead. Terrence Wilson, the single set. Receivers to the right and left. Back out there is Greg Dorsey, went off the field a moment ago. Ironman behind center, Gabe Luvera. And penalty markers fly as he takes the snap and gives to Terrence Wilson, but a flag down.
That's one thing we haven't seen a lot today is penalties. Neither team being penalized a lot. This will be the third against IUP, and I probably shouldn't say anything, but the Bearcats haven't been penalized so far in this ballgame.
Illegal procedure, the call against the Indians.
Hate to jinx them, a team that has had so much trouble all year long with penalties. So far, so good.
Top 25 score this afternoon. Number 23, Miami, leading Temple 34-0 in the second quarter. Big matchup is at Nebraska and Texas, that game in San Antonio, the Big 12 championship. That'll be getting underway a little bit later this afternoon. Second down and 15 for IUP. Back to the 31-yard line. Dorsey in motion. Hireman back in the pocket. Wants to throw and going off the left side. Has Dorsey open overthrown at the 5-yard line. Dorsey was open. Pass just missed him. And it goes incomplete.
A little bit interesting stat here, John, is the fact that IUP is relying more on the pass so far today than they have been the run. They've got 42 yards on the ground, 61 yards through the air so far. Usually, when you've got two guys averaging over 100 yards a game rushing the football and the quarterback averaging about 160, you'd think that they're going to go to that more often. But so far, they've had to use the pass because this Bearcat defense has done such a good job stopping the run.
Third down and 15 for IUP. A wide split in the backfield. Rebels the fullback alongside with Amir Du, the time. Back to passes, Ironman, and he rolls right side, looks to throw an incomplete. Pump faked and turned it right into the face of Grant Sutton, who was blitzing on the play. Ironman had no time and nothing else to do but get rid of it. He wanted to get the ball over to Tom Ripholz, the fullback, but the pass nowhere near him. Incomplete, and this brings up fourth down.
Another thing that could play a factor in the running game for IUP is I don't see over on that far sideline Terrence Wilson, their starting tailback. Amir Du has been out playing since Wilson got hurt not too long ago. We haven't seen Wilson back out, and I really don't see him over on the sidelines. He may be in the locker room.
Fourth down and 15 for IUP. As IUP going for it on fourth down. They're going into a fairly stiff breeze. High formation, receivers to the right and left side. Now timeout's been called by IUP. 6:15 left, Northwest in front, 7-0. We'll be back after this 1 minute timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Stadium with Matt Gorder. And down on the sidelines, Neil Ducker. I'm John Coffey. We'll go down to Neil after this play. It's fourth down and 15 for IUP. IUP coming back to the line of scrimmage as Greg Dorsey wide to the left side. And now the backfield Du will go in motion to the right side on fourth down. Back to passes, Ironman throws across the middle, and it is caught. Reception to the tight end now pops out of his hand. Ball rolls loose, and it is picked up by IUP at the 15-yard line. They're going to call it an incompletion. All right. Say John Jones is bobbling the ball, and it goes incomplete.
Good thing, because he would have had the first down by about a yard there. Terrence Wilson is coming to the sideline complaining because one of the officials on the far sideline had signaled it a completion. But the other two officials had better position over here, made the correct call, and it's going to be first down for the Bearcats.
Down on the sidelines is Neil Ducker.
Well, John and Matt, what happened on that play? As the receiver did, as the ball came into his hands, he caught it, and the official from the IUP sideline came in signaling a catch, but we had two officials, both from over here on the Bearcat sideline, and then one coming up from more towards the end zone, didn't come up and signal an incomplete pass. He did have one foot down, but before he took the next step is when the hit came in, and he dropped the ball. Back up to you guys.
First and 10 for Northwest, and handoff goes right side for David Jansen. He's to the 35-yard line, wrapped up at the 35 after a 4-yard gain. Runs into Faraji Mason, a defensive tackle. Northwest in front, 7-0 with 5:56 left in the first half.
I'll have to see how the old offense comes out here. They've been on the sidelines for quite a bit in this cold weather. I saw some of the guys kind of jogging around, jumping around, trying to keep warm, doing some stretching, trying to make sure that they stay loose and are ready to get back out on the field.
5-yard gain, second and 5 for the Bearcats. Jansen, the single set, receivers to the right and left. Now Mark Moss, who is lining up as a tight end, goes back as the fullback. On second down, back in the pocket, Travis Miles. Throws, caught, Moss with the reception at the 40-yard line, and he's to the 45. That will give Northwest a first down as he runs into Quincy Tisdale, an outside linebacker, and Mark Moss with the reception. Mark with his 15th catch of the year, and that's a first down for Northwest to the 45.
Having Tucker Woolsey heard earlier in the year added a new dimension to this Bearcat offense. They've used the tight ends as fullbacks, and they've used Tucker as fullbacks, and they've just added another another couple more pages in that playbook and done a good job with it.
First and 10 to the 45, still on their own territory as Ryan George goes in motion left side. Pitch goes left, and Jansen following Tucker Wolsey, blocking in front of him, goes left side to midfield, and they'll be gained about five again on first down for the Bearcats.
Continues to be a very fast-paced half here. The clock really not stopping very much. We haven't seen too many incompletions. Guys aren't getting out of bounds. No need to as the clock runs. We said it wasn't going to be a very high-scoring game, and 7-14 point lead is going to be very safe. It'd be nice to see the Cats punch another one in here.
Just shy of midfield, second and five coming up for Northwest. Cats going from our left to our right in the second quarter. They've got the wind to their back in this quarter. Now shotgun formation. In motion goes Moss to the right side, and back to pass is Travis Miles. Rolls right, looks to throw on the sideline, caught, reception at the 40-yard line. J.R. Hill with the diving reception just in front of Troy Flora for a first down into IUP territory at the 40-yard line on the right sideline.
That's the first catch of the day for J.R. Hill. Seven different receivers have caught passes now for Northwest.
And J.R. in the season, that's his 18th catch of the year. Came into this one with 233 yards receiving. He's also caught a couple of touchdowns. Now head to Indian territory at the 40-yard line. And they send everyone out. Three receivers to the left, two to the right side. And in motion, Seneca Holmes to the left side. So they'll end up with four receivers on the left side. And back to pass is Travis Miles. Throws left sideline for Seneca Holmes. Brings it down on the left sideline to the 40, to the 35-yard line. Spins to the 31-yard line, about 9 yards on the pickup. And that was all Seneca Holmes on that left sideline.
Nice job there by Travis Miles. What they did is they just left Seneca right there behind the line of scrimmage. He was the outlet. If Travis couldn't find anybody open out of the other four receivers he was looking at, then all he had to do was turn, look over, and dump it off to Seneca. That's exactly what he did, and Seneca did a good job with the football.
Seneca got off to a slow start as far as the number of receptions he had, but as the season's gone along, he's picked up a lot of catches and some big catches. 28 coming into this game, and he had 169 yards in receiving last week. Receivers to the right and left, offset eye formation. Pitch out off of the option to the right to Jansen. Not much room there, and he's brought down for a loss back to the 35-yard line as he couldn't get away from a defender off of the right side, and there to make the tackle for IUP was Roger Wilson, a defensive end.
And get the yardage, and Seneca has been doing that.
And he goes to the left side, a slot to the left, or the right side on the short side of the field is J.R. Hill along with Tony Miles. Shotgun formation on third down and five. Back to pass, Travis Miles throws back left side, and it is incomplete. Trying to get it to David Jansen. The ball hung up in the air. Mike Borisenko almost had a shot at an interception. He was intent on making the hit on Jansen, and we're fortunate that he was. He had a shot at the ball, and incomplete. This will bring up fourth down.
He's got linebacker mentality and not cornerback mentality there. He just wanted the big pop, and Jansen really could feel him coming because you could see Jansen pull away when the ball got there and kind of curl up, getting ready to take the hit.
On a fourth down play, David Purnell coming out for a field goal attempt from the 42-yard line, so 50-0. The Bearcats in front. Now Northwest going for it on fourth and six. The ball on the IUP at 35-yard line. So Northwest now going for it. They send three receivers to the right, three to the left. Now four to the left as Seneca Holmes goes in motion left side. And getting the pass is Tony Miles. They have some blockers in front of him. Tony, 30-yard line, has the first down, and he's tripped up at the 25-yard line. So a first down for Northwest off of the left side. Adam Boylan to make the tackle. But a very effective pass at the line of scrimmage to Tony Miles. He had three of his receivers in front of him to block, and Tony picks up the 6 yards and a few more on top of him for the first down.
And Seneca Holmes had the key block over on that far side. He got the big block that was able to allow Tony Miles to get that burst and pick up that first down.
First and 10 for Northwest at the 25-yard line. High backfield, receivers to the right and left. Again, Northwest up by a touchdown. Travis Miles behind center Joe Gleb will give the ball left side for Jansen. Jansen angles it close to the 20-yard line and picks up about five on first down again. Jansen doing a good job getting 4 or 5 yards of crack on first down.
Yeah, it's gonna add up as the day goes on, and it always helps your offense out. You get 5 yards a pop, you're going to move the football rather easily.
So this brings up second down and five for Northwest with 1:45 left in the first half. Just inside the 20-yard line with a wide split in the backfield, Tucker Wilsey And now Jansen in motion to the right side. Two receivers over to the left, and penalty marker falls as the snap goes to Travis Miles.
Yep, we're going to have a false start here. Basically bring up a second and 10 now for the Bearcats.
And yet another different look out of an offensive formation. I don't know if we've seen that one this year where they lined up a couple of receivers, but fairly tight to the left side.
And really, Jansen on that motion, he was on a sprint out to the right sideline. Usually when he goes in motion, he's not at that full-fledged of a sprint trying to get to the sideline there. So continuing to dig deep there in the offensive playbook is offensive coordinator Jim Svoboda.
From just inside the 25-yard line, second down. Second and 10 now. J.R. Hill will go in motion to the left as the shotgun formation. Snap goes back to Travis Miles. Strong rush comes in, gets the pass away to Tony Miles at the line of scrimmage. Tony slips as he gets to the 15, slides to the 14-yard line, will be close to the first down, but he slipped just as he got to the 15, needed to get past the 15 for first down. Let's see where they mark it.
Bearcats have done a good job setting up that screen play. This time they just go with the middle screen to Tony Miles. They've got the screen to Miles. They've got it to Jansen. They're mixing things up that way, and it's easy to do because that front push from the IUP is so big. If the offensive line just lets him go by, it's going to leave it wide open there in the middle.
He'll stretch it out here. And let's see, it's close. First down. First down for Northwestern. They just got it, maybe by the nose of the football.
Yeah, the same way IUP had that last first down on the other drive where they measured for it.
7-0 Northwestern in front with 1:08 left in the first half. Quickly to the line of scrimmage, the Bearcats go with two receivers to the right in Hill and Miles. Pump fake, handoff goes to Jansen up the middle. Jansen stopped at the line of scrimmage, falls forward, and gets to about the 13-yard line. And a timeout's been called by second down coming up for Northwest Missouri State with 56 seconds left in the half and a 7-0 Northwest Missouri State lead. J.R. Hill to the right side, also Tony Miles to the right. Shotgun formation, Jansen in the backfield as well for Northwest on second and 7. Back to passes, Travis and penalty marker falls.
Yeah, another little bit of a quick start here for the Bearcats. Movement on the right side of the offensive line.
Bearcats trying to get back into the championship game in Florence, Alabama for the second straight year. Penalty markoff, they'll mark this one back to the 17-yard line, so second and 12 coming up for the Bearcats.
Get a couple of touchdown lead on this IUP team. They're not an explosive team. They're not a big play team. They're the ball control type team, so it's tough for them to score some points quick.
Second and 12, shotgun formation again for Travis. Now they tried to snap it early, and the ball loose as it rolls around, still rolling loose, and it is picked up by IUP. They'll fall on the ball at the 24-yard line. They tried to snap it early to and snap it short, I should say, to David Jansen. Couldn't hold on to it. And
9 on KXCV KRNW.
On that snap to the tailback, it went to Brian Hackett instead of David Jansen. Now IUP will just fall to a knee as Brian Ironman takes the snap and goes to a knee with 46 seconds left. And IUP and Northwest in a battle here at Rick and Bro Stadium. The Bearcats in front 7-0 as the clock continues to count here.
Yeah, it's been a fun one to watch so far. Not fun as in what we saw last week and the fact that you're seeing a lot of scores, a lot of points go up on the board, but a fun chess match type battle. Two teams just battling it out, going hard-nosed at it, not putting a lot of points on the board, but the way they're playing here, it's just been a fun one.
20 seconds left as they count things down. And again, Brian Ironman will go to a knee one more time and go to the halftime locker room, and IUP will talk things over at halftime, as will the Bearcats, as this first half coming to a close in Northwest Missouri State holding on to a touchdown lead. 7-0 the score in the semifinals of the Division II playoffs. We'll be back with more from Rick and Bro Stadium after this 2-minute timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network. The kick. It's a high end over end kick, and it will be taken off of the right side by Kerry Cooper. Cooper out to the 10 to the 15. Stetter steps past the 20 as he's tripped up near the 25, and IUP will take over first and 10 from there. Receivers to the right and left side, a single set in the backfield for IUP out to the 25-yard line. Northwest leads 7-0. Third quarter just underway, and the give goes to Terrence Wilson. Wilson out to the 30-yard line, and it takes two to bring him down at the 30-yard line. Pickup of 5 for IUP. And there to make the first hit for Northwest was Frank Taylor. Also had some help from Ryan Miller, and this will advance, and pitch goes right side. Again, Wilson gets the carry. He's out to the right side line, has the first down past the 35 and out of bounds. Near the 40-yard line, he'll be just short of the 40-yard line, and a first down for IUP and Madden. Camarillo Ocasio goes wide to the left side, also Greg Dorsey to the left. Single set backfield, and Terrence Wilson as Brian Ironman with a long signal count to take the snap from Gabe Luvera. His center handoff goes to Wilson. He stopped at the line of scrimmage this time. No gain. The first one to hit him coming through was Alan Buckwalter. Also, there was Matt Vogie as well. And this will bring Ocasio to the right side with an offset eye formation on second and 10. Now the fullback, Rib Holtz, goes in motion left side. Back to passes. Ironman looks to throw the ball, and it's incomplete. A diving attempt by Dorsey tried to come back after. It goes incomplete at the 48 in Northwest territory. Charlie Pugh was there on the coverage, and this will bring up third down and 10.
Both Dorsey and Pugh went down when Dorsey stopped to come back for the football. They both went to the turf. Dorsey just couldn't get up in time to be able to get his hands on the football there, but turf continues to be a little bit slick.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network. Down at 10, back to passes. Ironman wants to go on the right sideline. Caught it out of bounds. Near the first down marker, he'll have the first down right at midfield as the reception on the right side. And again, out of bounds right at midfield. Ocasio with the reception and a first down for IUP.
One thing we've seen Ironman do a few times is on third and long situations, complete some big passes. Although he's not asked to throw the ball very often, when he does throw the football, he's very effective.
Well, right at midfield, first possession of the third quarter. IUP taking the kickoff, and they've marched it to midfield. So far, a five-play, 26-yard drive. Receivers to the right and left side. Ironman, the freshman quarterback out of Pittsburgh, audibilizing at the line of scrimmage, and goes to the tailback, Wilson, off to the right side. He's hit after about a two-yard game. As he was sandwiched, David Carlson comes over. Alan Buckwalter was there. And also Cole Sidwell, and this will bring up second down.
You heard Neil talk about in the first half how there's been a lot of jawing between these two teams in the ball game, and you're starting to see some of that even after plays, guys pushing each other around, and heard some extra whistles there because some guys were still going at it. We saw a lot of that last week against Northern Colorado, two teams that really had a lot of
West territory at the 47-yard line right hash. High backfield, receivers to the left side. Play action in the pocket, throws going deep, and it is almost picked off and goes incomplete, trying to go to his tight end, and stepping in front of the pass was Ryan Miller. Almost had it, couldn't hold on to it. David Carlson was on the coverage, as well as John Jones was the intended receiver. Jones at 6'4", pass a little bit underthrown, and it goes incomplete.
Ryan Miller is frustrated right now because he thought he should have come up with that interception, but it was a great play by Miller as he read that, just standing back there kind of in no man's land, playing center field, saw the eyes of Ironman where he was going with it, made a move on the football, was able to knock it incomplete.
Third down and 7, another third and long situation for IUP. Jeremy Sauve wide to the right side. Derek Brinkley to the left side. Single set in Wilson. Three-step drop. Pass right sideline. Caught. Sauve with the reception for the first down at the 38-yard line in Northwest territory on the right side. A quick angle pattern. Frank Taylor on the coverage, and this brings up a fed of Indiana University, Pennsylvania. Receivers to the left side. Single set in Terrence Wilson. Northwest with the touchdown lead. Ironman back in the pocket. And it collapses, and he's dropped in the backfield back in the 45-yard line. Guess who? That's Alan Buckwalter again to make the play.
Alan Buckwalter has been huge. Anytime that they get a drive going and they need something big to happen, Alan Buckwalter has been there today for the Bearcats.
And this will bring up second and long, second and 17 for IUP.
He's got a couple of sacks here. He's knocked down a pass, made some tackles in the backfield, and Alan Buckwalter just having a tremendous day this afternoon.
A halftime score, the big rivalry game between Navy and Army. Navy up 13-3 at the half. Here at Northwest in front, 7-0, 11-21 left in the third quarter. Receivers right and left, single set back to pass. Ironman on second and long, steps in the pocket, throws deep, and it is incomplete and almost picked off. And penalty marker falls. This should go against Northwest. Joe Quinn that caught the ball after his tipped, and he fell at the 25-yard line, but I think we've got an interference coming up on David Carlson.
Yep, David Carlson was there a little bit early, and to be honest with you, I think we've had a few that we've gotten the benefit of the doubt on this afternoon, so we really can't complain about this one.
So an interference call, pass interference call against that Carlson. Just trying to anticipate the pass across the middle. Anticipated just a bit early.
Should probably make the point that this officiating crew has done a great job here this afternoon. They've called a very good ball game, a very clean ball game. I know everybody realized that we were a little upset last week as far as the officiating went out there in Northern Colorado. Not a very good job out there, but these guys this afternoon have done a tremendous job.
I think one of the things they've done, they've taken control of the game. There was a point in the first half where both sides had a little bit of jawing back and forth, and they pretty much took control and let them know what was going to be tolerated and what wouldn't.
Well, they really didn't do it throwing penalty flags. They did it just making sure they were out there telling the guys what was going on.
First and 10 following the interference penalty. Back to pass is Ironman. Sets in the pocket going deep toward the end zone off the right side, and it goes incomplete, and another penalty flag falls, and this time another interference call. And this one in the end zone off of the right side. I believe Marcel Smith will get flagged on this one. So Ironman trying to go to the air off of the right as the IUP Indians had the ball on the 29 of Northwest. And this one going against Northwest, not a popular call among the crowd.
What a great job we had done penalty-wise in the first half. The Bearcats didn't have any penalties in that first half. Actually had two in the first half for only 10 yards, and now two straight plays, two penalties for a total of 30 yards.
So the Bearcat defense trying to keep IUP out of the end zone, but a couple of pass interference calls has helped out the Indian cause down to the Northwest 15-yard line. First and 10, 7-0. Northwest with the lead, 11:03 left in the third quarter. IUP on the first possession of this third quarter has been a 9-play, 62-yard drive. Now audibilizing is Ironman at the line of scrimmage. A two tight end formation. Handoff going to Wilson. Wilson spins at the line of scrimmage. Not much there, and he's stopped at the line of scrimmage for no gain.
Interesting point there, John. You mentioned how it's just a 62-yard drive to this point. Half of that yardage has come in penalties against the Bearcats.
10:46 left in the third quarter. At the 20-yard line, this brings up second down. A loss of just a few inches that time. And the crowd on the Rick and Bro sidelines. Both sides are coming to their feet here, trying to urge on this Bearcat defense. Second down and a long 10 for IUP. Terrence Wilson, the single set receivers back both sides. Pass play right side. Quick slanting pattern caught at the 10-yard line for a reception and a pickup of about 6 on the play. Just a quick slanting pattern off of the right, and the reception goes to Jeremy Salve.
Good pickup, and it's going to be a big third down here. I wouldn't be surprised to see IUP go to the air once again, as that's really been the only thing that's been effective for them here. They tried a running play the play before, and there was nothing doing there. So they might go to the air to try and pick up this first down or even go for the end zone here.
For the most part, Northwest has done a very good job against a very good rushing team in IUP. Wide split in the backfield. Two receivers to the left side on this third down 5 situation from the 9. Back to passes. Ironman dumps the ball across the middle, caught by the fullback for the first down. It'll be first and goal. They got the pass out of the backfield for Tom Reibholt, and he's brought down by Joe Quinlan, but inside the 5-yard line, first and goal coming up for the Indians.
You got to give IUP credit for changing what they're used to doing all year long. We talked about how they've had to go to the pass today. They're close to 100 yards passing. Brian Ironman is 10 of 21 passing for 94 yards today, so they've made the adjustment, and they've worked their game plan a little bit differently to try and get something done here against a team that's doing well against the run.
Northwest clinging to a 7-point lead. 9:24 left in the third. First and goal from the 3-yard line for IUP, and Ironman again audibilizing at the line of scrimmage. Gives up the middle. That is Wilson. He's stacked up after about a yard, maybe 2-yard gain as he's trying to read the hole. Stutter stepped across the right side and was knocked down, and one of those was Matt Vogie to help make the play for Northwest. Alan Buckwalter there as well, and this will bring up second and goal. They're going to go from about the 2-yard line.
Terrence Wilson up there, as you mentioned, John, trying to read the hole. It was a short story. There was nothing up there up front. The linebackers in that front line just stuffed every possibility that Wilson had or every choice that Wilson had to try and find some area to run.
Second effort got him down to the 1-yard line on second down. A goal situation with the wide split backfield. Double tight formation, and Wilson gets the carry again, and he goes off to the left side. He's in for the touchdown. He was stopped on his first attempt, rolled to the left, and gets into the end zone, and it's a 7-6 game. Northwest Missouri State with a 1-point lead, but IUP on their first possession of the third quarter marches downfield and they get into the end zone.
And another thing IUP did on that drive was take a ton of time off the clock. It was a 6-minute, 13-second drive.
14 plays, 76 yards. And Wilson into the end zone for the touchdown. Out for the point after attempt is Jeremy Boland. Boland this year, 24 of 31 on PAT attempts, a right-footed soccer styler out of Altoona, Pennsylvania. The kick is up, and it is no good. It is no good. Right to the right side. A huge miss by the field goal and a point after kicker, Jeremy Boland. And Northwest still has the lead at 7-6. Northwest in front, 8:37 left in the third quarter. We'll be back right after this one-minute timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
When the American Army was stationed there after the war, Tom Deacon joins me as always for Andre Watts and Stephen Kovacevic on Great Pianists of the 20th Century.
You can hear Great Pianists of the 20th Century Sunday evening at 6 on KXCV, KRNW.
Back at Rick and Broad Stadium, along with Matt Gorder and Neil Dunker, I'm John Coffey. And to kick off is Boland after a nice long drive by IUP, kicking into a win. It's a short, high, end over end kick. Ryan George calls for the fair catch at the 35-yard line. Heads up play by Ryan George at the 35. Northwest will get in good field position. Down the sidelines, Neil Dunker.
John and Matt, Matt, you mentioned it earlier, just before we took the commercial break. IUP took a lot of time off the clock, over 6 minutes off the clock. That whole time, the offensive unit had to just sit here on the sidelines and watch as the Indians drove down the field and scored. There's nothing more this offensive unit wants to do than get on the field right now and answer with a score of their own. Back up to you guys.
And fortunately, Northwest still with the lead 7-6 after the missed point after attempt. Seneca Holmes wide to the right side. Tony Miles to the left with an offset I formation. In motion goes Comer to the left side, the tight end. And Travis Miles with the give goes to Jansen. Jansen angles out to the left side to the 40-yard line to the 45. And he gets to the 47, a gain of 12 and a first down. He was hit by Jory Flora, a defensive back, but a first down for Northwest. And a great job of reading that hole, Matt. As Jansen was originally going up the middle, he saw that the hole was out to the left side, cut out left, and picks up 12 yards on a first down play.
Well, and you always wonder on a cold day like this how the offense is going to come off after sitting on the sideline for so long, and it looks like everything's right back to normal.
First and 10 for Northwest out to their own 47-yard line. 8:14 left, third quarter. Park Moss now races back as a fullback. He lined up as a tight end originally. Back to passes, Travis Miles. Rolls left, looks, throws, and it is caught and incomplete. A little bit high trying to bring it down was David Jansen out of the backfield. Leaped up, had it in his hands momentarily, but dropped it, and this brings up second down.
Yeah, Jansen just about was able to come down with that, but Miles had nowhere else to go.
Philadelphia was coming in on that play. Second down and 10, and they give the ball to Jansen off to the right side. Huge hole, and he dives forward, has the first down, past the 45, stumbles, and rolls to the 40-yard line in IUP territory. Great job again trying to roll to the right side, and Lamont Barrett, Monty Williams helped open up that hole for the Bearcats.
And that pushes David Jansen.
Lamont Barrett, the right guard, Monty Williams, the right tackle. Steve Comer has been out there at the tight end position. He goes in motion left side this time. Offset I formation, Woolsey, the fullback, pitch goes to Jansen. Jansen cuts back in at the 40-yard line, and he falls forward near the 36-yard line. Penalty marker down at the line of scrimmage. As Jansen tried to cut to the left side, this one may go against the Bearcats.
And another injured IUP player, too.
And that would be Roger Wilson, a defensive end.
Right arm, right shoulder area. It could be really similar to what happened to Wes Simmons. It looks like it could be a separated shoulder the way he's holding things over there.
Holding penalty against Northwest. They mark this back to midfield. And it's now first and 19 for the Bearcats. Again, penalties hurting at Northwest in the third quarter. On first and 19. Jansen out of the backfield to the left side. They've got three receivers to the right, and back to passes. Travis Miles throws across the middle. Tony Miles, the intended receiver. He holds on to it, and it goes incomplete. Oh. Just about had it as he was drilled. And coming hard was James. They call him the Jet Tindall, who made the first hit, and a sandwich type of play. As also there defensively was Joey Flora. Ball goes incomplete.
Well, that would have been a great catch if Tony could have come up with it, as he got drilled right as the football came into his arm. So not surprised that it fell incomplete with a good play defensively by IU. But if Tony could have hold on to that, it would have been an amazing catch.
Well, it would have been a spectacular catch and almost in the same category as the one Seneca Holmes had last week.
And that's tough to do.
Really. And Seneca comes wide to the right side this time, along with Tony Miles with the shotgun formation once again. Travis Miles back into the pocket. Sets and is going deep for Seneca, and he brings it in inside the 10-yard line. And he's brought down near the 6-yard line as he beats Joey Forum. and Seneca with another big reception. What a catch by Seneca Holmes.
Hey, it's old hat by now, John. That's not a big catch. That's just a normal play now the way Seneca Holmes has been. They needed to get almost 20 yards just to pick up the first down, and what a great pass by Miles. Miles has a tendency, or to Travis that is, has a tendency to float those sometimes. That time, threw it on a line, hit Seneca right in stride. Perfect pass, I should say. First and goal for the Bearcats.
And for Travis Miles, 18 of 25 passing, 207 yards. And it's first and 10 for Northwest. Actually, first and goal at the 7-yard line. Northwest with a 3 tight end formation. Jared James out there as the third tight end. Mark Moss, the tight end, goes in motion left side, and the handoff goes to Jansen. Jansen right up the middle, he goes with it, and he's inside the 2-yard line on a first down play.
Well, Neil said that the offense was ready to strike back and put another score on the board to get back what they lost to IUP, and they're showing exactly that Neil's exactly right on this.
Tim Buffone, nose guard, got Jansen from behind and perhaps saved a touchdown for IUP.
Yeah, I think he just saved the inevitable the way things are going for the Bearcats.
Well, we hope so here. Second and goal from the 2-yard line. 6:19 left third quarter. Give this time the ball loose, and Travis Miles falls on it back at the 12-yard line. A mix up on the handoff with Jansen. Travis Miles did the smart thing as the ball was rolling away from him. Just dove on it, fell on it, and Northwest to regroup.
Another defensive player for IUP, slow to come off the turf there. That's Tim Buffone, who was in on the play before. This time a little slow to get up, and he's going to trot off the field for this play.
He's a wide body, 6 feet, 1 inch, and 300 pounds, just a sophomore.
And he looks all that, too.
Third down for Northwest, third and goal from the 11-yard line. Three receivers to the right, two to the left as they clear out the backfield. Back to pass is Travis Miles, looking at a 4-man rush, rolls to the right side and throws the ball, and it's incomplete. It was caught on a bounce by Jory Flora, but IUP just using a 4-man rush, very effective in flushing Travis Miles out of the pocket. And here comes Northwest, a field goal unit. A quarter, Northwest with a 7-6 lead. Dave Purnell out for another point or a field goal attempt. He's missed on 2 field goal attempts this afternoon. This one right in the middle of the field at the 18-yard line, so a 28-yard attempt with the wind to his back this time. High snap, the ball loose, and diving after the ball is Jeff LeBlanc, and IUP will take over on the 20-yard line. They've had some trouble with snaps this afternoon. That went down at the 20-yard line.
Missouri State University, the Bearcats, and Nottoway Valley Bank, member FDIC, all winning teams.
On first down for IUP, point lead 7-6 over the Indians from Indiana University of Pennsylvania. Along with Matt Gwitter, Neil Dunker, I'm John Coffey. Second down coming up, 2nd and 6 officially. Fullback out of the backfield in motion to the left side, and Reibholtz back to pass his Ironman being pressured by Sidwell, and he brings him down. Back at the 12-yard line, penalty marker down. I think Sidwell may have got the face mask.
Yeah, he got a hold of his face mask there and got a hold of it and then got his hand off of it quickly, but you're still going to get called for that.
And an unintentional type of thing, I believe, where Sidwell was just reaching out and his Ironman ducked to try to avoid him, just ducked right into the hand of Sidwell and got his hand on the face mask. But they're going to call this one a big one, marking it back now all the way out to the 35.
Yeah, they gave him the personal foul, 15-yard variety. I think Cole just needed to do that to get his 15-yard penalty in the last few ball games. He's gotten a 15-yarder called against him, a couple of unsportsmanlike conducts, but this time a face mask call against Cole.
Boy, the penalties in the third quarter have hurt the Bearcats. Out to the 35-yard line, 1st and 10 for IUP on their own 35. Back to pass, Ironman again. Looks to throw on the sideline and is caught on the right sideline and out of bounds. About an 11-yard gain on that play and a first down for IUP. They got the pass on the right side for Carmelo Ocasio. And it's for another first down for the Indians. Then for the Indians, offset eye formation. Receivers right and left, Northwest blitzing as the handoff goes to Dew. Wants to go out to the right side, stumbles, breaks one tackle, breaks another. He's to the 50-yard line into Northwest territory, close to the first down. At the 45, Dew just would
great drive their last possession. This offense is showing that it's got that spark under them.
Second down and 1 for IUP on the Northwest 45-yard line. Handoff left side. Dew again gets the carry, and he has the first down as he's able to slither through a couple of Bearcat defenders and pick up 2 on the play and a first down.
Well, the offense has had its troubles here today. That means the defense, as it's been asked to do so many times before this season, is going to have to step up and get a big stop. I think probably everybody would think maybe no surprise. surprise. You know, unless he just cannot walk or cannot move, I think Brian Williams wants to be out there on that field.
3:49 left third quarter, Northwest in front. Northwest in front by 1.76. The quarterback for the Indians. Two receivers to the left with an offset eye formation as Ripholtz, the fullback, in motion to the right side. Back to pass. Armand throws the ball and it is caught as Ripholtz brings it down. He's knocked out of bounds by Brian Williams on the far side after about a 6-yard gain on the play. Pass hung in there just a bit. Ripholtz had to leap high to bring it down.
But it's right side of the offense. Got his hand up in the air. He's had a couple of passes knocked down at the line, so he kind of tossed that one up, made sure he wanted to get that one away.
Ocasio to the right side. Greg Dorsey to the left. Offset eye backfield once again. And rolling left side. Ironman ball knocked out of his hands. Still rolling loose. And Ripples comes back and falls on it. Back in IUP territory at the 47-yard line. But Brian Ironman rolled to the left side and again rolled right into pressure. And there was Brian Schertz that time who knocked the ball loose. Second game in a row that Brian Schertz has made a huge play defensively. And this will be a big loss back to the 43-yard line in IUP territory.
Well, you ask and you shall receive. I said the defense is going to need to step up here. But how many times have we seen a big third down pass by Brian Ironman? This is about the biggest third down that he's had to come up with here, but the defense has its opportunity here to change the momentum.
Big play by Schertz, the 6-foot, 289-pound sophomore out of Bettendorf, Iowa. This brings up third and 22 for IUP. Dorsey to the left side. John Jones, the tight end, to the left, and he wants to call a timeout. So IUP calls the timeout. IUP with a big third down left in the third quarter. 2:34 left in the third quarter. Northwest holding on to a one-point lead. IUP on their own 43-yard line. Wide split in the backfield. And Ironman back into the pocket. Pumps once, looks, throws right side. A screen play set up to do on the right sideline. He's to the 45-yard line and tripped up there. And Northwest Missouri State defensively did a good job. And there again was Brian Schertz. This will bring up fourth and long for IUP.
It's a good thing that he slipped and went down there because Brian Williams had a beat on him. Was going to lay his helmet right between the numbers and get a big hit. Wilson hadn't slipped, he'd probably still be down on the turf right now.
And a punting situation for IUP. The first punt of the third quarter. Matt Dannell out to punt again. Tony Miles back deep. Cats could use a good return this time. Northwest with the one-point lead. Good snap, and he gets it away. And away from Tony Miles. Tony calls for the fair catch. And bobbles the ball. Does he fall on it? IUP indicating they recovered the fumble, but Tony was there to fall on it. So Northwest gets a good break on the play. As they continue to unpile, Northwest again. The officials rule that Northwest has the ball. They'll take over. 1:47 left in the third. Northwest up 7-6. Back in 30 seconds, you're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Experience our nation's capital firsthand when you're on the go with public radio. April the 10th through April the 13th, cherry blossom season, KXCV, KRNW will be taking a four-day getaway to Washington, D.C. Our tour includes a visit to the Holocaust Museum, the Capitol, the White House, and Arlington National Cemetery. Reservations for the tour must be made by December the 6th by calling me, Gail Hull, at 660-562-1163.
On first down, the carry to David Jansen goes off the left side of the line, turns the corner past the 25 and gets out past the 30 and will be about a yard short of the first down as he went off left side. 1:33 left in the third and Northwest Missouri State holding on to a slim 7-6 lead over IUP.
And Ryan Hackett going to trot out of the field. Jansen a little slow getting up after that last hit. He's going to have to come over and shake some cobwebs out.
Second down and one for the Bearcats on their own 33-yard line. Tony Miles to the right side. J.R. Hill over to the left side with the eye backfield. The give goes to the fullback Tucker Woolsey, and he should have the first down as Tucker crosses the 35 to the 36-yard line. Tucker with his 50th carry of the year and picks up the first down.
Hopefully Jansen's going to be all right, which I'm sure he will be. He's got 126 yards and 21 carries this afternoon.
1:04 left in the third quarter. Northwest with the wind to their back in this third quarter. I'm sure they'd like to do some damage here while they still have a little bit of a breeze behind them. Carson Newman leading Northeastern State of Oklahoma 28-0. That's a third quarter score. Handoff goes to Ryan Hackett. Hackett on the draw play, breaks loose past the 40 on the left sideline, picks up about 8 on first down, goes off the left side, finally hauled in, and there to make the play for IUP was James Tindall.
Tindall, a guy that can fill in for David Jansen back there. His, of course, his best fill-in role came earlier in the year against Southwest Baptist when both Jansen and Dan White were hurt, and he rushed for 217 yards.
Hill to the left, Miles to the right side, offset I formation. The give goes on a counter play left side. Tucker Woolsey gets the carry again. He's got the first down. Tucker past midfield to the 48 in IUP territory. So they're using Tucker Woolsey on this drive, and he does a good job just angling to the left and picking up the first down.
So that's another thing with Jansen coming to the sideline, that they go to a different part of that playbook offensively, and they're going to Tucker, something that IUP probably wasn't expecting coming in. Tucker hasn't got a whole lot of carries the latter part of this season as they've started to go to the tight ends more.
And the clock winds down. That's the end of the third quarter. The score, Northwest 7, IUP 6. Back with the fourth quarter of the Division II semifinal.
The world may wait for the weekend, but the news knows no day of rest.
And here, Weekend Edition Sunday from 7 until 9 on KXCV, KRNW.
The fourth quarter, Northwest Missouri State in front by 1-7-6. They have the ball in IUP territory from our right to our left at the 48-yard line. Handoff goes to Jansen. Jansen stuck at the line of scrimmage as Kawasi Asari makes the tackle after a one-yard game, and this will bring up second down for Northwest. Let's go down to the sidelines and check in with Neil Dunker.
John and Matt, through the first three quarters of this game, probably the biggest players that we've seen, the guys coming through the most, have been this Bearcat offensive line. They've given Travis Miles all kinds of time to get back and pick apart and throw to his receivers, and they've given David Jansen and Tucker Woolsey the holes they needed to run all over this IUP defense. We'll see if it continues through the final 15 minutes.
Out of the shotgun formation, second and 10. Back to passes, Travis Miles now rolls out of the pocket, steps up, looks downfield, continues to look, now pumps a couple times and throws incomplete. Through behind J.R. Hill at the 30-yard line, incomplete. This brings up third down.
Neil, talking about the offensive line, the way things have gone this year, they've been just about as automatic as Dave Purnell on extra points. I mean, you can count on them anytime of the
radio network.
From the campus of Northwest Missouri State University, we are 90.5 KXCV Maryville and 88.9 KRNW Chillicothe. Currently in Maryville, we have 42 degrees and cloudy skies.
Back to pass, Travis Miles on third down and 10 on the right sideline, being chased out of bounds as he's knocked out of bounds on the far side. This will be a loss of 6 or 7 for Northwest. Mike Warrensinko blitzing, makes the play on Travis Miles. One of the few times we've seen IUP actually blitz this afternoon, and this will bring up fourth down, and the Bearcats forced to punt.
John, another good decision there by Travis Miles. They lose some yardage there, but with as good a punter as Jeff LeBlanc is, that's not going to make a whole lot of a difference. Instead of trying to throw the football downfield and maybe coming up with an interception, that's a difference between the playoff Travis Miles and the first of the year Travis Miles. So at the beginning of the year, he may have thrown that one and turned it over.
Jeff LeBlanc to punt once again for Northwest. Joey Flora back deep to return this punt. And here's the punt by LeBlanc. Gets it away as he has some time. Hangs it high in the air, and a fair catch is called for. And it's taken at the 24-yard line. Northwest in front, 7-6, 14:03 left in the game. Back after this 30-second timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Bringing community service home.
A message from the National Association of Broadcasters and this station.
On first down, Ironman tries to pass it on the left side. Overthrown, goes incomplete. Again, attending it for Tom Reibolt out of the backfield. Incomplete. This will bring up second and 10 for IUP. They're taking over on the 25-yard line with 13:59 left in the game. And Northwest in front, 7-6.
Ironman really right on his percentage as far as completion goes. He completes just over 50% of his passes on the season. Right now he's sitting at 13 of 25 passing.
Second down and 10 for IUP. This time the give goes to Terrence Wilson, and he's stopped at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there. And there was Brian Williams to help make the play. Also Jeff Googe in the area, and this will bring up third down. Northwest, again, has done a very good job stopping the IUP running attack.
Yep, and it's been those big linebackers in the defensive line that have been doing all that. The line is allowing the linebackers to come up and make the plays. They've done a good job of stuffing holes, and it just hasn't been much room up front for both running backs from IUP.
Wilson, 16 carries, 54 yards, and he's rushed for over 1,000 this year. Receivers to the right and left on third and 10. Ironman back in the pocket, straight drop, looks to throw across the middle, and it is caught. Reception at the 40-yard line, breaks loose from a tackle to the 45 to midfield. Camarillo Ocasio spins to the 50-yard line to the 49 in Northwest Territory.
Again, another look. He's got him in the semifinals.
1-point lead for the Bearcats, 7-6. Greg Dorsey to the right side. Ocasio to the left side with a single set. This time, Amir Du in the backfield. Back to pass. His arm going deep on the right sideline. Trying to go for Dorsey. He hauls it in and step in the 10-yard line, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown. A 48-yard reception as Arma connects with Greg Dorsey, who beat Frank Taylor on the play, and Dorsey into the end zone for his fifth touchdown catch of the year.
Good pass, good catch. Touchdown IUP. Dorsey had a two steps on Frank Taylor. And just a perfectly led pass, allowing Dorsey to make the catch and get into the end zone.
And the Bearcats fall behind for the first time this afternoon, 12-7 with 12:53 left in the game. Now we'll have to see what IUP wants to do. It looks like they may line up and go for two to try to make up for that lost point after earlier. And they will go for two. Taking some time as they go to the huddle here. Northwest Missouri State trailing now 12-7 after a 48-yard pass play. And the reception from Ironman to Dorsey. And for Ironman, that's now his 17th touchdown pass of the year. IUP to the line of scrimmage. Ball on the left hash at the 3-yard line. Has Northwest lining up on defense to try to stop this. Now IUP comes to the line of 3 left in the game. Northwest trails now 12-7. IUP scoring on a 48-yard touchdown pass. Ironman behind center, back in the pocket, wants to throw the ball, and it's incomplete. Trying to go on a quick slanting pattern to the right side for Derek Brinkley. Goes incomplete. The 2-point conversion fails. And the Bearcats still trail, though, as IUP has taken the lead for the first time of today. 12-7 the score, Northwest.
Damn. Reservations must be made by December the 6th by calling me, Gail Hull, at 660-562-1163. Be on the go with Public Radio, KXCV, KRNW.
Here's a kick by Bowen, a high kick, and is taken off the right side by Tony Miles on the sideline to the 10, to the 15. Cuts back into the 20-yard line, to the 25, and he's hit at the 27-yard line. The Bearcats will take over first and 10. Northwest trailing 12-7. 12:42 left in the game, and again the Bearcats down.
Yeah, they're used to playing from being down in the playoffs. They were down to North Dakota most of the way. They were down to Northern Colorado time and time again as they really just bounced back and forth, although they were down pretty big going into the fourth quarter. But the way IUP holds on to the football and as much time as they take off the clock, we're not going to have the football in our hands very many more times.
First and 10 for Northwest, a shotgun formation. Receivers to the right and left as J.R. Hill goes in motion left side. And they give it to Jansen. Jansen on the right side. He's to the 30-yard line, outside to the 35. Has the first down as the penalty marker falls. He gets out to the 37 and out of bounds, but a flag down.
That flag traveled about 20 yards in the air. I'm going to be interested to see what the call is here.
And they're bringing this one back. It's going to go against Northwest. And in the second half, Northwest really has been their own worst enemy.
Yeah, they really have.
Holding against the Bearcats.
That's about 60 yards in penalties just in the second half.
This goes back to something that we talked with Coach Churchman in our pregame about, how Northwest would have to take advantage of every possession because of the ball control type of team IUP is.
Yeah, you're exactly right. That's the seventh penalty against the Bearcats for 71 yards, and 61 of those yards and penalties have come in the second half.
After a good gain by Jansen, they bring this one back to the 16-yard line on the right hash, so it's first down and 20 for Northwest. First and 20 for the Bearcats. Sending Holmes to the left side, over to the right side, Tony Miles. Shotgun formation for Travis. And Travis gives to Jansen, who hands off to the left side for Tony Miles. Tony on the reverse. He cuts into the 20-yard line, breaks loose to the 25-yard line, outside to the 27, to the 29-yard line, as he was brought down from behind. And there to make the tackle for IUP was Jeff Jackson, a freshman linebacker. An inside linebacker out of Murraysville, Pennsylvania, but a good run by Tony Miles. Now Northwest in a little bit better situation, where it's now second down and 6.
After giving the handoff, Travis Miles came the other way, knowing it was a reverse, and threw the key block there. He got a big block and a big defensive end, Jay O'Neill.
Tony Miles to the right side, Seneca Holmes to the left, ball on the left hash at the 30-yard line. They give to Jansen. Up the middle he goes on second and 6. He scores loose, has the first down left side to the 40, to the 45 from behind, brought down at midfield. A diving tackle made off the left side by James Tindall, but a first down for Northwest. And now some players from IUP who go into the Bearcat sideline having some words with some Bearcat players as well.
Yeah, Tim Buffone was the loudest of the loudest from IUP. He was over right in the face of Brian Williams, who's over trying to help the offense out, doing some cheerleading over on the sideline. Whatever happened to him in the first half that knocked him motionless for a little bit is definitely out of his mind right now.
One of the things that did, it brought the crowd to the life. They've been somewhat quiet this afternoon.
Yeah, and that's what the Bearcats need. The offense has got to get something done here.
First and 10 for Northwest into IUP territory at the 47-yard line. Moss out of the backfield, goes to a tight end position off of the right side, and they give it to Jansen. Jansen wants to go to the left side, tries to turn the corner, and it leaps over one of his blockers past the 45 to the 43-yard line. It'll leap over Monty Williams, who's trying to lead the way for the Bearcats, and for Jansen, picks up about four, maybe five.
55 yards.
20 miles to the right side. Holmes to the left side, wide split backfield as Woolsey joins Jansen. Play action back to passes. Travis Miles trying to go for Tony, and it's incomplete. Broken up on a quick slanting pattern off of the right side. There was Joey Flory, who knocks it away. Tony hit after by Mike Borincinko, an inside linebacker. The crowd thinking it might have been a little bit of a late hit. No flag, and this brings up second down. Actually,
stop there.
So third down and four for Northwest at the 42-yard line. Tiger Holmes, 20 miles to the right side. Two tight ends, Comer and Moss out there. Single set, and David Jansen behind center Glab. It was a quarterback, Travis Miles, and Travis, straight drop. Throws out of the backfield, caught by Jansen. Jansen trying to cut back in, not many blockers, but he scores loose, and he's close to the first down marker. It will depend on the mark here. He had virtually no blockers in front of him, and he just angled left side, went past a couple of would-be defenders, and close to the first down.
Yeah, the pursuit was so good that time for IUP. Jansen just went against the pursuit, found it some room against the grain there, and was able to get some yardage. It looks like he's going to be just a bit short here, but I wouldn't be one iota surprised to see them go for it here if it is fourth down.
So fourth down coming up for Northwest. Well, I guess I'm jumping the gun just a bit here. We'll have to see as they stretch it out. But it is going to be fourth down. Fourth down and about 6 inches.
Yeah, if they can't get 6 inches on a play, then they don't deserve to have the football. So we'll see them go for it here.
Northwest went on it with a big fourth down play in overtime against North Dakota and made it. Now they'll stretch it out again on the hashes. Fourth and inches, even closer than 6 inches. I'd say about 3 inches is all they have to pick up.
It's a quarterback sneak away. This offensive line can pick up 6 inches for the Bearcats.
It's been a very good day for the offensive line. 10.5 minutes left in the game. Northwest trailing 12-7 to IUP. Semifinals of the Division II playoffs. The Bearcats, the defending national champions, trying to return to Florence, Alabama, but they have to come from behind to do it. Fourth and inches. Offset I formation. Travis Miles gives Tucker Woolsey. Woolsey continues to keep his legs chugging forward. Should have the first down. Knocked back. We'll just have to see on the forward progress.
Woolsey may have picked up 7 inches. Needing six, I think Tucker just got seven there. That's about as close as you want it to be.
Tucker coming to the sidelines now as they umpire. No indication by the officials, and they're going to bring the chains out for another measurement.
Yeah, the looks of it here, this time they do have it by about three quarters of the football.
10:21 left in the game. Northwest down 12-7. Touchdown will give them the lead, and they pick it up by a football. Not by much, but by a quarter to the right side. Sending Holmes to the right, over to the left side. George, along with Hill and Miles, as they send everyone out. No one in the backfield. Travis Miles with the long count. And one step drop, looks to throw, and it's caught by Tony Miles, and he'll be stopped in the backfield for a loss on the play, a loss of a couple. And reading that play well was James Tindall, the strong safety.
Roger Wilson also got a hand on the football there as he tipped it and sent it out of its spiral a little bit. Boy, they've really had to dig themselves out of a hole so many times, the offense has so far today.
Still a lot of time at 9:34, Northwest trailing 12-7. But it'd be nice to get into the end zone here. J.R. Hill to the right side, Tony Miles to the right. Seneca Holmes over to the left side and a shotgun formation for Northwest. Back to pass is Travis Miles. Deep drop, rush comes in, rolls out of the pocket, and will run with the ball on the left sideline. He's to the 40-yard line and out of bounds. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage and may have picked up one on the play. He was chased out of bounds by Kwasi Asari, and this will bring up third down.
The way things have gone, the way IUP has held on to the football today, the Bearcats, if they can't do anything here on this possession, will probably only get one more possession in this ball game. The way IUP has averaged about five minutes per time of possession every time they get the football. So if the Cats can't do anything here, they're only going to have one more shot at it.
Third down and 9 for Northwest from the 36-yard line. J.R. Hill, Tony Miles to the right side. To the left side goes Seneca Holmes. Northwest needs a good third down conversion here. They're 42% on third down conversions this season. Out of the shotgun, Miles rolls left, has time, can't find anybody open now, throws right sideline, it's caught. Reception to Jansen. Jansen to the 25, in the 20, to the 15, 10, and he's caught from behind inside the 10-yard line, down to about the 5-yard line. Jansen just accelerated after Christian Gould. 9 minutes left in the game. Northwest trailing 12-7. Three tight ends out there. Jared James along with Mark Moss and Steve Comer. And they give it to Jansen. Jansen onto the left side. Continues to go forward, and he's down to about the 2-yard line, trying to angle out off of the left with that handoff. And one of those was Adam Boland, a free safety, who comes in to help finally stop that play. Asari also was there. And this will bring up second and goal. Second and goal from the 3-yard line.
Last time we had first and goal, we ended up with nothing. We lost yardage and were forced to try and attempt a field goal, and a bad snap gave us nothing. So we've got to do something here with it.
Again, the three tight end formation. Mark Moss lining up on the left side as a slot. High formation backfield. Now Moss in motion to the right side. And they give it to Jansen again. Jansen is upended. Upended short of the goal line. And again, it was Asari there who lowered his head, got him by the shoulder pads, and just flipped him over. And he falls. 9 left in the game. They place it down at the 2-yard line. So it's third down and goal from the 2. High formation. Three tight ends once again. In motion, Mark Moss to the left side. And Travis Miles wants to throw back into the pocket on play action. Rolls to the left side. Continue to roll with it. Runs with the ball off the right side. Breaks loose from one tackle. Still scrambling on the left sideline. And still scrambling, trying to look for somebody to pass to him. Finally can. He's brought at the 23-yard line. So a 33-yard attempt. And the winds have died down just a little bit as he'll try to get this one away. 6:45 left in the game. Northwest trailing 12-7. Snap down. The kick is on the way. And it will be good. Just makes it. Just makes it. So David Purnell connects on the 33-yard field goal.
Tats. Phone World Wildlife Fund at 1-800-CALL-WWF and help leave our children a living planet.
Back at Rick and Broad Stadium, Northwest Missouri State to kick off. That last drive, a 13-play drive, took 58 yards and a field goal by Dave Purnell of 33 yards. And Northwest Missouri State trailing by 2, 12-10 as Purnell getting set to kick off. And the kick is on the way, and he gets into this one. A high kick taken off the right side on the run. Bobbled at the 20-yard line. Ball is loose, and Northwest Missouri State recovers the ball. What a huge break. They'll recover it at the 17-yard line. Tony Sly falls on the ball at the 17-yard line.
John, we talked about it in that last drive. We said that the Bearcats may get one more possession because of the way IUP takes it. I told you during the break, I said we needed a turnover, baby. We got it.
And that may be the biggest play of the game off of that kickoff. And it was a...
As he was catching the ball there. So I don't want to take complete credit for it, but, you know, give me a little bit here.
All right, it's first and 10 for Northwest. Handoff goes to Jansen. Jansen on the left side to the 15-yard line, and he's down to the 13. 6:24 left in the game. Northwest trails by 2, 12-10. And let's see if Northwest can take advantage of the turnover.
Well, if Neil's going to take any credit, he needs to start double-staring the defense here. We need to get a touchdown, get it in the end zone. A field goal would put you ahead here, but we talked about how momentum and sparks and all that. Right now, the offense has got the spark that they needed. The crowd, once again, back into it. Great opportunity here, and we've seen so many missed opportunities today. The Bearcats are due.
First turnover of the game for IUP. It's second down, second and 4. Coming up for Northwest. Out of the I formation, the give goes to Jansen again. Jansen up the middle, and he gets to the 13-yard line. No gain, maybe 1, and this will bring up third down. Clock counting at 5:40, and this will bring up third down for Northwest. Third and it looks to be 3 yards.
David Jansen is having his biggest game of the season since he rushed for 200 yards against Truman State. Behind that for Jansen, 152-yard effort against Missouri Western. So today, the second biggest day of the season right now at 168 yards on 29 carries for Jansen.
5:16 left, Northwest Missouri State trails by 2 on third down. Play action rolling to the left side is Travis Miles. Travis is hit and he is dropped. He's dropped at the 18-yard line, and that time he was nailed. And it was Osari again who has had a big second half for IUP.
And Purnell, their troubles, but they've come up big all year long in pressure situations just like this one here.
And it doesn't get much bigger than this one as Purnell. Again, the wind coming out of the north, but not quite at the strength it was earlier in the game. So the snap down, the kick is on the way, and it is high enough, it is deep enough, and it is good! Northwest Missouri State regains the lead with 4:21 left. The score is Northwest Missouri State 13, IUP 12. We'll be back in a minute. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network. Field goal by Dave Purnell. A 35-yard field goal, and the Bearcats have regained the lead, and there's 4 minutes and 21 seconds away from a return trip to Florence, Alabama.
And how big is that missed extra point by Jeremy Bowen by IUP? Instead of a tie ball game, it's the lead for the Bearcats.
Oh, it's huge. Or even how big is the missed two-point conversion attempt they had after that to try to make it back. Here's a kick by Purnell, a short end-over-end kick, and Dew runs up on it at the 20-yard line, catches it this time at the 25, breaks loose from a couple defenders, hit from behind and brought down at the 36, so IUP will have the ball in good field position. Let's go down the sidelines to Neil Dunker.
John and Matt, this defense knows that the rest of this game, with just 4:12 left, is set squarely on their shoulders, and I don't think they want it any other way. They don't want this game to end any other way than with them shutting down this IUP offense. Back up to you guys.
And this is going to be 8-12. Brian Ironman at quarterback. Receivers to the right and left, and back to passes. Ironman being pressured, and he breaks loose from one tackler, looks to throw the ball, and it goes incomplete, intended for Dorsey. Thrown behind him, incomplete. Buckwalter was on the coverage.
Actually, out on this near side, Cole Sidwell on the coverage. It was Buckwalter that had originally caught a hold of Ironman's shoe and nearly brought him down the back there. As Alan Buckwalter continues to play well, how many times have we called his name? Not necessarily a lot, but we've called his name in some big situations.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
From the campus of Northwest Missouri State University, we are 90.5 KXCV Maryville and 88.9 KRNW Chillicothe.
And the handoff goes right side for Terrence Wilson, and he was drilled in the backfield. Brian Williams coming in, among others, to make the tackle. A huge loss on the play, and the defense is playing with as much emotion as they played with the entire day.
And we see another one of those Brian Williams goofy dances, this time a takeoff of the chicken dance, it kind of looked like, as he came up there. He looks over to the student section on that far side, starts waving his arms in the air. He wants some noise. This is the biggest third down of the season for Northwest.
It's third down at 16. IUP has had very good luck on third and long situations this afternoon. Back to passes. Ironman in the pocket. Throws across the middle. Tipped away. Incomplete. Brad Williams got his paw on it and knocks it down.
This time he goes with the airplane dance. What a huge play by Williams. This is going to force IUP to punt it away with 3:23 left in the ball game.
Northwest by 1 point, 13-12. You can start to sense on the Bearcats sideline that they're just a little bit closer toward Florence, Alabama.
They need a couple of first downs. They need to take some time off, keep it on the ground, get some first downs.
Matt Dannell to punt. Tony Miles back deep at his 30-yard line. Dannell will have the wind to his back. Good snap and gets it away. It's a nice punt by Dannell. Backpedaling is Miles at the 26-yard line left side. He angles out to the left to the 30. The left sideline to the 35, to the 40. Tries to cut back in. Stutter steps and he's out of bounds at the 43. Northwest having a good field position. 3:11 left. The Bearcats by one, and we'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Charles Wadsworth here. Chamber music is a lot like life. It's meant to be enjoyed. I invite you to join me and some of the country's finest performing artists for the Spoleto Chamber Music Series. I assure you, it'll be a feast for your ears. Spoleto Chamber Music here on PRI.
You can hear Spoleto Chamber Music Tuesday evening at 7 on KXCV, KRNW.
First and 10 for Northwest on their 44-yard line. 3:11 left, and Northwest holding on to a one-point lead, 13-12. High formation, receivers to the right side, and the give goes up the middle. Jansen with the carry, and Jansen stopped at the line of scrimmage for only 1 yard. Northwest really needs a couple first downs here with 3 minutes left.
Yep.
Take the snap, as he'll take it from Joe Glab. And he He gives it to Jansen. Jansen off to the left side, breaks a tackle midfield on the left side to the 45, gets loose to the 40. Brandy is down to the 35-yard line. It was about one tackle away from a touchdown on the left side. And finally brought down by Joey Flora. Big tackle for the IUP players.
He was one arm away from a touchdown there. Flora just got him with a one-arm grab there. Jansen was starting to lose his balance, so he was able to get that one-arm tackle on him, but he breaks that, and he's home free.
Northwest with a one-point lead, 13-12, 2:15 left in the game. At the 34-yard line on the left side, Bearcats with a first down. 34-yard line of IUP. Two receivers to the right side. High formation backfield. And they give it to Tucker Woolsey, the fullback. Up the middle he goes. He picks up four on first down to the 30-yard line.
Another couple of plays and one more first down, John, and the Bearcats should be able to run this clock out.
1:45 left at the 31-yard line. And for Northwest, Travis Miles looking over to the sideline, trying to get a play signaled in. And they'll take as much time off the play clock as they can. It's at 13 seconds now. They come to the line of scrimmage from the 31-yard line of IUP. Two receivers to the right side, offset I formation. The clock down to 5 seconds. Down to three, down to two on the play clock. And the give goes to Jansen. Jansen, right side, lowers his shoulder. He's at the 25-yard line, cuts into the 15. Ball's loose. It's loose at the goal line, and it's dived on by Northwest into the end zone. Touchdown, Bearcats! Touchdown, Northwest! David Jansen had the ball knocked down at the 5-yard line. Ball rolls into the end zone, and the Bearcats recover. That is Sky Corner, the senior from Maryville, who recovers the ball into the end zone, and that gives the Bearcats some breathing room.
Punch the ticket, baby. Punch the ticket. 1:09 to go. The cheerleaders have already got their Road to Alabama shirts on. The jackets come off. Punch the ticket. What a huge play. Scott Corder, and fittingly, does it in the hometown of Maryville.
19-12, Northwest with the lead with 1:09 left. So Dave Purnell will come out for the point after attempt. Dave has been automatic on point afters this year. He's had 64 in a row. Northwest, 1:09 away from a return trip to Florence, Alabama, and to play in the national championship game, and most likely a rematch with Carson Newman. Here's the snap. The ball's down. Kick is on the way. It's good as Purnell drills it through. 1:09 left in the game to score. Northwest 20 and IUP 12. We'll be back right after this 1 minute timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
7 until 9 on KXCV, KRNW.
A crowd to their feet as Dave Purnell will kick off with 1:09 left in this one. 20-12, Northwest Missouri State in front. We'll check in with Neil Dunker in just a second as Purnell getting ready to kick this one away. And here's the kick, a high, short, end-over-end kick, and Dew runs up on it at the 20-yard line to the 22. He's out to the right side to the 30, and he's hit from behind at the 32-yard line and brought down at the 34, and that's where IUP will take over first and 10. Let's go down the sidelines to Neil Dunker.
John and Matt, you guys mentioned the cheerleaders have their back-to-Florence shirts on. Well, another indicator that these goalposts could be coming down right now. The event staff coming out, they've got all the padding and everything off the goalposts. They've taken all of the yard markers away. They're putting that all that stuff away. I think we could be seeing a couple goalposts coming down for the second year in a row here at Rickenbrode Stadium.
IUP with a first and 10 from their 33-yard line with 1:03 left. Northwest with four down linemen. Back to pass is Ironman. Looks to throw the ball across the middle. Incomplete. Trying to get to his tight end, John Jones, who was drilled on the play. Goes incomplete. And this will bring up second and 10 for IUP.
I think the plan this year is to try and save one of the two goalposts. They've got event staff down or all around guarding one goalpost down here on the south end. The north end, there's a couple guys over there, but not enough to surely take over what they're about to see in a few minutes.
Second down and 10 for IUP at their 34-yard line. Northwest with the lead, 20-12. Defense needs to come up on this last series. Here's a pass play by Ironman, and it's incomplete. In and out of the hands of John Jones. Jones that time seemed to be anticipating a hit. It goes incomplete, and this brings up third and 10.
Two more plays here is what the Bearcat defense is looking at. It's going to be third down and 10, and it's obviously a situation where IUP is going to have to go for it. Nothing behind you is all you need right now, and keep them in bounds. If they do get a completed pass, you've got to keep them in bounds.
Over to the right side, two receivers to the left as well. Brian Ironman behind his center, Gabe Luvera. He's back in the pocket, sets, looks, throws right sideline. Salve with a diving catch. Does he keep his feet in bounds? I believe he does. That'll be close to the first down with 48 seconds left.
And right now, it's not first downs that are going to do them a lot of good. They've got to cover a lot of yardage here in less than a minute.
48 seconds left. Northwest with the lead, 20-12. Looking for a rematch with Carson Newman, which was ahead 28-0 at last word against Northeastern Oklahoma. Receivers to the right and left side. From the 44, back to pass is Ironman, rolls to the right side. Being pressured, Buckwalter coming in, gets him and brings him down. Matt Fogey to help out, and how fitting is that? Alan Buckwalter coming over to help make the sack. He started things off with the sack on Ironman back in the first quarter.
Alan Buckwalter again and again and again has come up big here, played tremendously. What a great effort by Alan Buckwalter today.
Who's all the news that isn't? How am I doing for time? Okay, I'll make it short. The town of the week, and most importantly, me, Michael Feldman. Don't miss it every weekend on this public radio station.
You can hear What Do You Know Saturday morning at 10 o'clock on KXCV, KRNW.
And back to pass is Ironman, and he'll be brought down in the backfield with 27 seconds left. Northwest in front, 20-12.
No more timeouts. IUP doesn't have any timeouts. They're going to have to get up, get it snapped if they want to get another playoff.
Brian Williams on the sack that time for Northwest. The clock continuing to count at 13. Northwest leading 20-12.
Watch for Ironman to ground it here.
9 seconds away from a trip to Florence, Alabama for the second straight year for the Bearcats. Ironman back to pass with 4 seconds left. Going deep on the left sideline. Throws it high in the air and it's intercepted.
Yes!
Charlie Pugh with the interception. He's brought down at the 30 and the Bearcats are Bama bound for the second straight year. Coming out onto the field. They're at the north goalpost right now, trying to take that one down. They're trying to get the south one down as well, and I believe the event staff fighting a losing battle with the south goalpost.
You see the event staff guys just backed away right away. When they saw that rush coming at them, they knew there was no way they were going to save these goalposts. And they're setting a record. The goalposts coming down a heck of a lot quicker this year than they did last year.
More experience at it.
I think so.
Northwest Missouri State will have a chance to defend their national title from 1 year ago, as they will be most likely facing Carson Newman. We'll try to get an update on that score. The latest one now we have, Carson Newman 35, Northeastern. Now that's 42-7. Carson Newman leading Northeastern Oklahoma with 3:52 left in the fourth. So the Bearcats will face Carson Newman, a rematch of last year's championship game, next Saturday in Florence, Alabama.
Yeah, it's going to be 1998 all over again, but last year, this one is sweeter for different reasons. Last year, it's the first trip down, a great team getting into the national championship game. This year, it's sweet for the simple fact of all the battles that the Bearcats had off the field with injuries, the death of Phil Vogie not too long ago, and just everything that they have had to battle through to get back down to Florence.
Again, Northwest Missouri State battles back to win this one today, 20-12, the final score, as the Bearcats move on to the championship game in NCAA Division II football. We'll be back with more after this timeout. You're listening to the Bearcat Radio Network.
Northwest Missouri Cellular, 660-582-3334. We're nothing but Northwest Missouri State University and KXCV KRNW.
Northwest Missouri State University salutes the Sigma Phi Epsilon and Tau Kappa Epsilon fraternities on the recent completion of their new homes. Hi, this is Mike Johnson of the Northwest Alumni.
Right, they gotta go pee in the